Hello, everybody, and thank you for tuning in to another episode of The Real Debaters. I'm Micheal Petrow, your host and one of the debaters on the show. This week, the podcast is sponsored by the Toad and the Hole Pub and Eatery in Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada. If you were cruising through the city and you need a place to go have a great beer or some good conversation or drink some incredibly delicious cocktails, look no further. The Toad and the Hole offers so many things. For starters, great local pub food, delicious English-style fare, with a great beer selection, domestic, imported, and some local craft breweries if you're into the local craft beer scene. Then if you're into whiskey, they've got the whiskey bar attached to it next door, over 200 different whiskeys to choose from. If you're into whiskey, I think you know where I'm headed with this. There's limitless options. I bet you can't drink them all in one night. And lastly, downstairs is The Cavern, which is their live music venue. Unfortunately, I don't have a list of the events coming up at The Cavern. Next podcast, we should have that. So thank you to the Toad. We appreciate it. Hanging out in the living room this week, Martin Navarro, Mark Cowell, Christopher Stanton. Those are the three boys that decided to come see me and argue Rampage. Specifically, Rampage in regards to how bad the movie was with Dwayne The Rock Johnson. I know I've said in the past that I'm a huge Rock fan, but that movie was shit. So I decided, wouldn't it be fun if we picked some of our favorite monsters and creatures from different movies and recreate what Rampage should have been? So without further ado, I'll find the switch for the reel, and you enjoy the show.
Just from Pornhub, like that didn't take long.
Is that the number one search?
There's a lot of banging in Shameless.
I just wanted to see the openings, if there was a compilation of the openings.
You see a whole lot of male butts having during sex in Shameless.
Did you?
That's the one part they can show.
There's a lot of male buttocks.
Yeah. I learned something new today.
Are we recording right now?
Yeah, we.
Excellent.
I love it when we ask that.
How y'all doing?
Didn't get the crack reference. That was a good one.
It's so natural.
Forever lost in time. Forever lost in time.
I read today. I didn't know this, and it was kind of interesting. So, The Hateful Eight was put onto Netflix I don't know, a year ago now.
Or three.
Yeah, whenever. Nothing on Netflix is current to when things are released, but. So they re-released it in April of this year as a mini series.
Oh.
So all of the edited footage was put back in, and then it was cut into four mini series episodes. So the Hateful Eight that's on Netflix right now is the mini series.
Oh,
but it's the same movie.
It's the same movie, but it's everything that he couldn't get into the movie because it was originally like.
So it's a bit longer.
It was originally like 3.5 hours long, right? So it is longer. So all he does is. Stops it, and then it's like, okay, act two is now the second episode, and act three is the third episode, and act four is the fourth episode. So there's a lot of things that I haven't seen it yet, but there's a lot of things that you miss apparently from what he edited. Anyways, my point is Brad Pitt mentioned today that they're doing the same thing with Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, which is 4.5 hours long. So oh, it's gonna be perfect, but they
just make Lord of the Rings already. Yeah. Quinn,
no kidding,
it.
Right?
Jeez.
But
that'd be an interesting Lord of the Rings. Sorry, I want to say that would be, I would love his take on something like a Star Wars, Lord of the Rings, or you know, one of those fantasy movies.
He's tied into some Star Trek thing.
Yeah, I heard that. I want to see that.
That's still kind of.
But I remember hearing he was tied into like Friday the 13th at one point. Like, he says a lot of his ideas, they don't.
Yeah, and then
we're supposed to get Kill Bill 3. I've heard that could still happen, but who knows?
Do you guys? It's funny that you talk about the miniseries. I don't know if this is a unique memory for me when I was a kid, but miniseries were so cool. Like, I thought, like a TV miniseries, because we didn't have anything else to watch. Like, when I was a little kid, right? Like, watching stuff with my parents, and I remember, like, the miniseries coming on TV. And I'm like, you mean it's going to be a show that I get to watch?
Yeah,
like,
I remember
there's
that.
Like multiple parts of it. And I remember like Shogun.
Yep.
Right? Like movies like that where it's like, there's like three or four parts of this. Like, it's not just a one night show.
It's
like
a one and done.
We're going to sit down and watch this next Tuesday night at 7. You know, it was a cool thing as a kid that I'm like, it's a really long show and I get to watch it.
I completely agree. V was, at, to I can't remember, I don't know her name, but the girlfriend in Deadpool is the lead in V. She's the lead alien.
Oh, okay.
With her short hair. Great movie podcast. We can't remember the names of actresses. But
we never claimed to know anything.
Yeah, no, we didn't. None of this is fact.
Just make it up.
Just our
fact we've claimed to not know.
Sally Jane. It was Gabrielle Union, I think. Just an earlier reference.
Before you got here, we were trying to figure out
the
female lead in Bad Boys 2. And I thought it was Gabrielle Reese, but I think she's a volleyball player.
Gabby Reese is a, yeah.
Yeah, she's a volleyball player. So then he...
There's a Photoshop that I want to see to promo this episode.
Yeah, for sure. And then we found out it was Gabrielle Union and her two, I mean, and whatever, if she wanted to do something else, but her two big claims are Bad Boys 2 and Bring It On, the best cheerleading movie ever.
Mike actually thought Gabrielle Union was an organization that Gabrielle Reese was
part
of. Yeah,
the Gabrielle Union.
Yes.
The Union of Gabrielles. Our rights matter too.
There's four of them in Hollywood.
Yes, I took it literally.
Would it be called GAG? Gabrielle Actors Guild?
Is that
a SAG?
Yikes.
Well, but it's like the union, right? So it'd be like GAU.
GAU. GAUG.
GAUG.
That doesn't look nice on a business card.
We're GAU, guys. We represent all the Gabriels.
It doesn't have quite the flow of like PETA or something.
Yeah. or FEMA. PETA, FEMA, whatever. Yeah. Yeah, so anyways, back to the whole miniseries thing. But there's a lot. I can't remember all the characters, but there's a lot of pivotal characters from that era that they did a ton of shots with. That are now going to be in the movie that you did. And apparently they say one girl's performance, this breakout artist, they say that just her one scene of screen time is Oscar worthy.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. But again, like you say, Chris, like Quentin Tarantino talks out every orifice of his body. So really, how much can...
Well, and he's saying his next film is his last film.
So. Yeah. And that's a great way to get people to go see your last film. That's probably not your last film.
Yeah.
Anyways. Hi, everybody. How are we all doing?
It's okay.
Good.
Yeah,
good,
we're good. All right. So in the building, for everybody who's listening, we have got Martin Navarro, we've got Mark Cowell, and we've got Christopher Stanton and myself, Michael Petrow, this week.
Hello, Chris here.
Hello,
Chris
Martin here.
And
yo.
that's Mark talking.
Smack in the house.
Talking some smack in the corner.
DJ Marky Mark.
Full rizzle.
Please don't come here modeling underwear. That's all we're asking. Okay, you're not
we
that
feel
Marky.
Those good vibrations. You know what I'm saying?
I think he's gonna play out. He's gonna play out that the mind fuck. He's gonna start modeling underwear in your house. Fuck. He's slowly gonna take over your life.
He was gonna single white female me last week, but now he's doing.
He's doing
it this
for
week.
Real. That's the joke.
This would be the perfect time to do the prank.
Yeah. He's already drinking whiskey.
Yeah.
So
a couple more of these. I won't know what happened to me, Marcus. So, Martin, let's start with you this week. What'd you watch, buddy?
I just finished Netflix, The Dark Crystal, Age of Resistance.
Thrall. At its center, the crystal of truth, the source of all life. The Skeksis have corrupted it. And now our world is at risk from the Darkening.
What is the Darkening?
Behold.
I saw something. A vision.
You read too many stories.
No, this was real!
Everything the Skeksis ever told us was a lie. And now everyone and everything is at risk.
And what'd you think?
I loved it. It's awesome. Like I was saying to Mark and Chris earlier that I watched the original one as a kid and then rewatched it again just to remember what like the story.
Yeah, you
in need, preparation for the series.
Need a little bit of a blueprint.
Yeah, and the original movie was good. It was a little kiddie and like the story was average. But like I said, the coolest part is the Muppets. Like the whole movie is Muppets. And
for those who haven't seen The Dark Crystal,
Jim Henson's
Jim Henson's one of his masterpieces.
Yeah,
for sure.
Should I give? Yeah, look up the synopsis.
Like better than Fraggle Rock?
Yeah.
Well, I said one of. I didn't say the.
Okay.
Fraggle Rock ever have a movie?
It did.
It did.
Ooh, it did. Yeah. Straight to DVD or VHS, or whatever.
Straight to VHS. Or beta.
Straight to beta. Straight to beta.
Laser disc.
While we're walking down a completely unrelated path to what Martin's talking about, no, actually, Jim Henson wise, does anybody know? Okay, just quick sidebar.
Sure, yeah.
There's a Muppets Christmas movie.
Yes, there is.
Seen that?
A Muppets Christmas Carol?
Wait, there's a Muppets Christmas Carol, but there's a littler known Muppets Christmas movie.
Yeah, where everyone gathers at the house.
Where they all gather at the house.
They're snowed in, aren't they?
And it's the Muppets, Sesame Street,
Fraggle Rock,
all in the same.
Oh my goodness!
At the house. It's
that's where they do. What's the band? Dr. Teeth.
Oh yeah, whatever. That yeah.
They do
with Animal. With Animal. Yeah.
They
right?
do. Yeah, with Animal. They do Jingle Bell Rock.
Yes,
like, that's their version. That's my favorite version of Jingle Bell Rock. I didn't know there were other versions. But
it's so hard to find. Yeah. I went looking for it a few Christmases ago. I found a digital copy, but I found like some old VHS recording of it, and it's really kind of obscure, but it's fantastic. And the Swedish chef is trying to cook Big Bird the whole time. So he's chasing, oh, it's the big turkey. He's chasing Big Bird around. It's fantastic. Anyways.
I think that'll be on Tubi. That's probably on Tubi.
If you haven't watched it, go find
check it out.
Okay,
now.
Guys, anybody listening, if you know of if you can find us a copy of this.
I bet you anything my mom has the Christmas VHS still.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, my mom's
because she had that and like the California Raisins Christmas and all these other big specials, the Garfield one probably.
Yeah, no.
I bet you she has it somewhere.
We are tasking your mother with this. And anybody listening, if you know what Mark is talking about, send us the link to not download it. And
I want a hard copy VHS.
Yeah, I do want. I want the plastic that you know, yeah. The old Disney masterpiece.
Or possibly a pirated Chinese DVD.
Why did you look at me when you said that? Yeah.
Like he had it.
I'm just trying to play to the crowd. You're so racist.
Okay, anyway, so your synopsis of... tell us what your view of Dark Crystal
I don't want
to
give it away if you haven't seen it.
Yeah,
but like
spoiler alert, anybody skip this if you...
I don't want to give it away for anyone in the room. I recommend you watch it. It's good. It's what I liked about it is it grew up with the audience because a lot of them saw it when they were kids, when they were like, you know, in grade school and stuff like that. And it's really dark and darker than I expected it to be. And it's like it's not for kids. Like I wouldn't show my nephew or niece this at all. I think they'd get nightmares.
Really?
Yeah, they deal with some serious shit. And you're just like, oh, fuck. But it's like it's cool because it's all Muppets. And you're like, it's still Muppets. But the way they pull it off, you're like, oh, man. Actually felt emotion for these Muppets, so it's like crazy.
Interesting. Well, it is. I mean,
it's got Taron Egerton, you know.
Oh, Eggy from
he's
the
lead. He's the lead. Who else? There's a lot of like names. Sigourney Weaver's in it. Yeah,
Ellen Ripley.
But they're just voices.
Voices. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. She's in it, and then Lena Headey is also in it.
Is it Lena Headey?
Headley? The Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
Lannister lady.
I thought it was Headley.
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 Lena Headey.
I thought it was Headey, but anyways, she's in it. A lot of other characters.
It's Hawkins, it's actually. We're not even close.
Lena Hawkins.
No, are you like? Yeah. Are you actually confirming the name?
I'm still trying to find out about the Muppet Christmas.
It's tough to find.
Just googling Muppet Christmas doesn't. They made one in 2002, which that's probably not the one you're talking about.
Was that the Scrooge one?
Yeah,
no, this one just looked like a more modern one that they tried. Yeah. I don't know.
Ooh, this is like old.
But yeah, even when you go view all, it's not coming.
Like
up.
There might be a little bit of racism
it was
in
I think it was
so much racism in that.
You
problem.
Know what? It was more of a special. I think it was like an hour or 45 minutes. Whatever.
It like might have only appeared on TV and might have not been released on.
Yeah.
Oh, like format. Once in my mom, because they would have promoted the hell out of it back then. And my
it's
mom.
It's obscure, but it's fantastic.
It like a CBS like special Christmas thing. Yeah, I know what you're. Yeah, those were great. I still look forward to any sort of like a Michael Bublé Christmas special.
Here we go. 1987.
Whoa.
Oh, there you go.
What's it called?
A Muppet Family Christmas, 47 minutes.
Oh, wow.
It's amazing.
Sounds like that was definitely made for TV.
Still trying to find. Oh, you have to scroll down for this one.
45 to 47 minutes is like your TV.
IMDb has it as 8.1, so that's not bad.
Is it 1990? No, not 97. 87, you said?
Yeah. I want to see if it's on Amazon.
Wow.
I know I had a really hard time finding it like 3 years ago, but now with all the streaming services, somebody might have got
somebody's
it.
Somebody's going to pick it up for sure. So how many Dark Crystals would you give it?
out of 5, I would give it like a 4.
4?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's some Dark Crystal shit going on. Okay, so I remember watching the first one as a kid. Like, that's definitely like Willow, Dark Crystal, Never Ending Story. Like they're all Labyrinth. Like that's all in the same fantasy wheelhouse. But I would definitely have to rewatch the movie to understand the series. I don't remember so much about it. I have the images in my head, you know, because they're it was watched.
Well, the movie is basically about like there's these group of race. There's a race called the Skeksis who basically are the ruling class of Thra, which is the planet, and they eradicated this race called Gelflings.
Yes,
by stealing their essence to live forever, and now there's no more Gelflings around. There's like I think Jan, he's the one left, and he meets another Gelfling, Kira.
And then they
were the one who like make the crystal hole and destroy the Skeksis.
I remember the big scene when they're all in like the big circular room.
Yeah. Yeah,
that's the one.
That's when they all come back together with the I guess what are they called, the Druids or something? They're like there's the Skeksis have like a yin and a yang, so they have one race that like that's super like wise, and the Skeksis are super greedy and corrupt. So they're both one, and they become one. They become
Yes, I do remember that. Yeah, yes.
At the end of the movie. Yeah, it's cool. I recommend seeing it. It's cool. It's a nice little series.
Yeah, it's on the list for sure.
Yeah.
Cool. Super cool.
Mark?
I never watch anything. I have my OCD.
Taking back the title I gave
my you. My OCD is super kicked in, though, like, because I'm started watching Shameless.
Spare us the wiener act. Bullying is a vital part of every ecosystem. It teaches kids resilience. The world is a rough place. Bullying is like getting inoculated. It's a vaccine. And you little shits, you gotta learn to stay away from people like my son. That's what you learn when you get punched in the face by a bully. How do you think Steve Jobs turned out so great? Bullies. And I guarantee Junior here will be getting the hottest chicks when he's 30 because he got bullied today. You want your kid to peak now? My kid will be picking up roadside garbage in an orange jumpsuit in 10 years. Your kid will be in med school, curing cancer and getting laid. You're welcome.
And somebody said, my girlfriend Chrissy said, you should watch Shameless. I've seen, you know, claiming like she's watched a lot of it, right? So I'm like, watch a couple episodes and then she goes and does her thing for whatever, goes to work or whatever. I find some time. And next thing you know, I'm on like season 6. And she's like, what's going on? I'm like, I thought you watched this all. She's like, no, I've only seen like to blah, blah. I'm like, that's like season 3.
It's like an afternoon of television.
Seasons, yeah. So I'm obsessively watching like 96 hours worth of Shameless that's on Netflix.
We've been tracking this each week, and I'm now invested in where you are each week with.
Yeah, I'm in season 7.
Man,
so
you
I'm
are plowing through,
and there's only 8 seasons on Netflix. Yeah. So I'm halfway through season 7. So I don't have much to go.
Are they not getting any more seasons on Netflix, or are they just like?
Well, there's season 9 just completed this year, so I'm assuming they'll launch it on Netflix.
Yeah,
and then apparently most of the cast has signed on for 10. So it's not off the air yet.
Emmy Rossum, keep it going.
I agree.
She's done. Yeah, Emmy Rossum.
Oh, do they kill her off?
No. Well, please. I might eventually get to it one day. So
yeah, me
it's
too.
It's a fantastic send off.
They don't kill a lot
does
of characters
get,
off.
Does
they
she
just
get
like
the Infinity
she's
Gauntlet?
She's the daughter, right? That's
she
the daughter.
Yeah, Fiona. Okay.
Fiona. Yeah.
Yeah.
Does she get the Infinity Gauntlet?
Yeah.
She snaps.
Yeah.
But they make such cool, like there's one season where you're convinced that William H. Macy's character is done for. And then, you know,
Frank is a cockroach. He'll survive a nuclear bomb.
I was just going to say that.
And then suddenly he's doing like fantastic. And then, you know, it's the way they make some really obscure storylines, but it kind of works.
Yeah, it is. It's so over the top. Like it's in every scenario that Fiona rescues the family and Frank drags the family through and all of the shit the kids have going on, you can see some reality, but then there's always an element that's like way over the top. Like you've clearly seen where they have to dig up the dead body to get the drugs.
Oh God. Yeah.
Right. And you're like, okay, that would never happen. Like just look at the four of us. How much would it take to assemble us to go dig up a dead body? Like, first of all, we'd have to muscle the fucking fortitude to break into a cemetery. Well, no, we don't have to, right? But like, it's just one of those things where it's like, okay, you have to be so down in the depths of your shit that you're going to dig up your dead mother's body.
And they have
to get drugs.
The character, like Carl, the second oldest kid or whatever, is like, was kind of a little kid in the start. Now he's like a fucking man. He goes off to like military school and
yeah,
like it's crazy.
Iraq to crack.
Yeah. No, he went from crack to Iraq. He went the other way.
Yeah.
Was that the one that went to juvie?
Yeah, he went to juvie for a season.
Yeah.
And then came back and was running shit on the street.
Yeah, he got seriously wrapped up in that that yayo.
He had the cornrows selling guns at school.
And like fell in love with that guy, the some general's daughter,
the
right?
Cop's daughter.
The cop's daughter, which is kind of how, remember when he shows up and he takes the cornrows out and he's like, I'm trying to, it's a very beautiful moment, actually.
It is. There was the scene I saw today was actually, not to ruin anything, but that same cop's daughter, right? He's convincing, he's kind of, I don't know where the cop's from. I should figure that out because I've seen him in some movies. Anyways. He's kind of helping Carl out because his daughter kind of screwed Carl over and he hated Carl when he was dating his daughter. Right. But now that his daughter screwed Carl over, he's kind of sided with Carl because Carl was actually a decent kid. And, he's trying to help him get in this military school. He goes for the interview, gives him a good recommendation, whatever, but they say, oh, we're only hiring minorities. Like the rest of the class is full. And Carl just loses his shit and leaves, whatever. And then he goes for a DNA test. Right, with this cop, and they and when they go for the DNA test, because he thinks he's got part black African American in him, right? Because Liam is his little brother is apparently got the same parents, and he's black. So they say it's 2-for-1 DNA test right now. So he talks the cop into doing the other one just because he goes, oh, it might be interesting. So they go back for their results. Like, Carl, you don't have any African American in you, but you are 35% Native American from the Apache tribe that can be dated back. And they talk to the black guy and they're like, and your ancestors, you 22% Irish that could be dated back to the Pilgrims. And then Carl turns to the black guy like, you're saying your ancestors killed my ancestors?
Yes, definitely.
Because the black cop's been giving him the whole, like he said at the beginning, if I found out any of your ancestors owned any of my ancestors, I'm going to shoot you. And then turn the other way around. It's pretty interesting.
That is, yeah, that was a funny.
So anyways, it's good.
Yeah.
I can't, I'm so wrapped up in it that anytime I have any time to consume media, I watch Shameless. Right now, just to get through it, because I want to watch other stuff.
No, I understand the TV
but
time
I can't out. Bring myself. Like, when I sit down and Chrissy turns on, like, one of her tape shows, I'm like, can you shut that off so we can watch Shameless? Yeah. really need to get through this.
Well, and that's the great part about being in a relationship is that, well, not that I wouldn't say great, but it's the funny part where, you know, you're both watching a show, but you have some time to kill, and, like, you cheat on your partner with the TV show, and you get, like, two episodes ahead. And then you're like, okay, I don't do this anymore.
You've tried to pretend you didn't watch it?
Yeah, you pretend like you didn't watch
you
it.
You don't want to do that.
And then you're like, and then it's like you clearly out yourself because you know what's coming. You're like, watch this. How do you know? What did you fucking watch? Yes, I watched an episode, honey. I'm sorry.
I tried to do it with my dad with the new Star Wars, with Force Awakens, because I promised we'd go see it together. And then I went and saw it with somebody else. He's like, you ready to go? And I'm like sitting there like, oh my God. I'm trying to like fake
feigned
excitement.
Surprise. I remember when we went to go see
Force Awakens. Dad, don't listen to this episode.
I took my mom, my stepdad, and Shauna and me went to go see Force Awakens. And I'd already seen it. And Shauna got up to go to the bathroom just before they kill Han Solo. And like loud as I can, sit your ass down. You can't piss right now. And she's like looking around packed theater. I'm like, get over here. This is pivotal to the fucking plot. Anyways.
That's right at the end of the movie. Why would you go? Like, you can feel that it's almost done.
Yeah, and you can feel there's like that's in the
like,
middle.
That didn't come out of nowhere.
Yeah, they were building that scene up for a while. Yeah. It was like something's going to happen.
Or
something's
even if
happen.
He didn't die, it still seemed like a pivotal part of the movies. So.
She loves the movies, but God bless her, she just doesn't give the same fuck that I give, which is perfectly fine. Chris, what did you watch this week?
Not this week, but the last movie I saw in theaters was Ready or Not.
I can't believe that in half an hour, I will be a part of the Ladomas gaming dynasty empire.
Dominion, we prefer Dominion.
I honestly can't wait to be a part of your family.
There's just one more thing, and then you are officially part of the family. So, at midnight, you have to play a game.
Why?
It's just something we do when someone new joins the family.
A game. What game? Hide and seek? Are we really gonna play that?
Well, the rules are simple. You can hide anywhere. We then try to find you.
So there's no way for me to win, right?
I mean, stay hidden till dawn.
No, thank you.
Good luck.
Starry.
Here I come.
Samara.
Is it the hide and seek?
Yeah. Basically, she's getting married to a dude that's from wealth, and their family plays a game on the wedding night.
Oh, that one, yeah.
She picks a card. It's up to her to pick a card, and there is different games. Some of the other relatives are like, we played chess and did this, blah, blah, blah. Unfortunately for her, she gets hide and seek, which is the one game where they get to hunt her after 100 seconds is counted, just like hide and seek. But she doesn't really know yet. So it kind of plays off that for the rest of the movie.
So are the other cards just actual just games? Like they're just actual, chess is chess.
As far as
Snakes and Ladders.
Yeah, as far as it seemed, it was just like that. They kind of make fun of like, I got whatever the other ones were. I think the one was chess, but I can't remember.
What timeline does this, like what era does this take place
it's
in?
Modern.
It's really?
It'd be this year. It has that kind of old looking feel. Just because it is the
old house.
Yeah, it's an old mansion, creakety thing, and yeah.
There's something really creepy about rich people getting together to play games.
And yeah, they kind of it's not. The thing is, it's a dark comedy. It's not a
really.
Horror. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's dark comedy. It's played. There is laughs. Like when someone dies, it's not like it's more like shit. Yeah, exactly. So there was some pops that I found funny. There was some stuff that's maybe sort of forgettable. I think it could have just been a little bit more punch to it. Samara Weaving, I think that's her name.
That's the lead actress?
Yeah, she was great. She was fantastic all the way through. Like, there's a shot of her where she's gone through, I think, just shit, and she's got, like, her bridal dress still on.
Like, legit, literal shit, or just, like, just
pretty,
figurative?
Yeah, without spoiling, it's one of the games. Not literal, but she does, it's a rough night. But there's a shot of her. Her bridal dress is still on. It's just torn to pieces. I think she probably has a shotgun at this point. And she just got like these like beat up Converse shoes on. I was like, that's a Halloween costume right there. I'm looking forward to at least seeing one of those just on like Reddit or something like that. So
I'm assuming Adam Brody is the husband. Is that the one she's?
He's a brother.
Oh,
brother-in-law.
All right.
Or now brother-in-law.
California. So, yeah. I just remember him from Orange County.
Yes. Well, I was actually going to say my rating of this movie would be it was the second best Adam Brody movie of the year.
What's the first best?
Shazam.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and I didn't have any. There was no draw for me to go see that.
I haven't watched Shazam. I hear Shazam was better than expected.
Shazam was actually good.
Well,
I saw it.
That's what I heard. The trailer made me chuckle, and then I saw it. We're like, man, that was fun. I hope it gets a second. It is tied to the DC cinematic universe, but
if they keep doing that,
I don't know what's going on.
Nothing's holding that universe down anymore.
There's not a lot of ties.
They need to reproduce Shazam on all DC stuff. Like that was amazing.
It was great, and they've opened it up. There could be more.
Yeah, so. I'm hoping so.
Before I get into mine, I found it really funny. So Swamp Thing is out on television right now.
Well, that's DC too.
Yeah,
canceled like right away.
But it did get canceled. Like they announced when it was airing, and then a week later they're like, "And the show's canceled." But we'll air it anyway, so you get to see what.
Oh, I thought they canceled it after they debuted it. Episode
they did, but it's all the episodes that they've made are airing still.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I guess they got.
But that's it.
That's it.
Like, I remember the original Swamp Thing being super cool.
The cartoon, right? Was it the cartoon?
No. Like the live
movie.
Action. Yeah.
Yeah, the live action.
There's a cartoon though, right?
There was.
I were toys. I had a Swamp Thing toy.
I had a Swamp Thing. I had one that glue in the
dark.
There's
Scooby Doo battled the Swamp Thing.
They did. Those universes crossed.
Was that? So was it an actual monster or was it just a dude who was like,
was
just
well, dirty. Clearly,
get out of my swamp.
Clearly pulls a mask off at the end and he would have got away with it too if it wasn't for you meddling kids.
Yeah. Crotchety old guy in the bayou. Yeah. This isn't the Swamp Thing I was expecting.
Just a guy who hasn't taken a shower in a couple of years. Right? Yeah.
A guy with no cell phone.
It's old man Smithers.
So I watched, which is where this whole podcast idea came from. A little foreshadowing for you. I watched Godzilla King of Monsters.
What did you see, old man?
Godzilla. Godzilla. Godzilla.
Uh-huh. And thoroughly enjoyed the shit out of it. Like, you have to walk into it with an open mind because there's a huge gap. Like, has anybody else seen it here yet?
No, not yet.
I've seen the last one. I saw was the
you
second
saw it
one.
In theaters or on the streaming or something.
I streamed it. Yeah, we watched it here, and there's a big gap in between what happened in the first one to the second one, but it all ties together. Like the story is very linear in that regard. But there's some nonsense that you have to suspend. The audience is asked to suspend a lot of disbelief. They make this thing called an oxygen bomb, which just blows up like a nuclear bomb, but removes all of the oxygen from the environment. So anything that needs oxygen is dead. So you die of suffocation by a blast from this bomb.
What, how is that just any that better work? Than just a nuclear bomb?
That's what I'm saying.
Does the oxygen come back? How does they get rid of the oxygen?
And these are the things that I'm trying to explain to you is that there's no explanation for how the oxygen comes
it's
back
like just
once you.
It's a weird dead zone?
Yeah, exactly. And then all the fish and, okay. and whales, they float up from the
it's
bottom.
It's kind of a cool
the,
weapon.
It is a neat weapon, but they get this great idea and they're missing the follow through, right? It's wow. a shitty golf swing. So you've got how throughout time, all of the Titans, these are the Titans that we're all, except they're not the ones that we've been raised to believe.
Like the Greeks.
Like the Greek Titans, exactly. These are just monsters that were put into hiding because of their deadly force on Earth.
Kaiju.
And there's a real weird population control issue that's tied into it. So a lot of moving parts, but like as for an entertaining fun movie, the monsters are ridiculously cool. Like there's 7 or 8 of them.
I like the anime. Have you seen the anime?
The one on Netflix? Netflix? I started watching
good.
It. Yeah, it was done well.
Is it
yeah.
tied into
are there
the
any
new
like
movie?
Classic?
No, I don't think so.
Monsters, like, does Mothra come back?
Mothra comes back. Mothra is actually very pivotal.
Is
to
it Gamora?
What's like the three? Mega God.
Mega God.
Oh, what the hell's the name of the three?
Please.
It starts with a G. It starts with a G.
Gaia something.
Giga?
Maybe. They're all very Asian influenced. To keep with it,
so
the monarch aspect from Kong,
yep.
Skull Island is in it. We all know that Kong versus Godzilla is coming out.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. So this is a sequel to the 2015 movie or 14 movie, right?
Exactly.
And then the next movie is that Kong
versus Godzilla, but Kong Skull Island is the middle movie to Godzilla and Godzilla King of Monsters. Like, there's some backstory and canon that comes from the monarch scientific community that discovered Kong and Skull Island, that also discovered Mutu and Godzilla in the first Godzilla movie.
Oh, okay.
I'm
so there's
to see yeah. how this works.
It
King Ghidorah. King Ghidorah.
That's it.
The
yeah.
three-headed lizard.
The three-headed lizard. And the fight scenes between the two of them are very epic. And there's the Ken Watanabe needs a speech coach. I feel like his Asian accent is great in The Last Samurai, but he's so...
Mike, Asian is not an accent. It's Japanese.
Sorry. Thank you.
There's no such thing as an Asian accent.
Ignorant white guy sitting over here. His accent. His Japanese accent.
You have to say,
Asian country, the accents couldn't be more different from one to the next.
Yeah. We have yet to have a download in China. We won't now. So
lost China.
Yeah.
What about, we got ones in Japan, though?
No, not yet. No, I'm just...
That's done for sure.
That's done for sure.
We're big in Japan.
Have we hit any part of the Asian market?
No, because it does give Europe, but we haven't had anything there yet. When we do, I'll let you know. Trust me.
Is there somewhere people comment or anything like that? Like, is there the ability to if they wanted to?
Have we heard from Utah? That's all I want to know.
Utah is like a faint pulse. It was a big spike on the radar for a minute.
On which episode were they all of a sudden like, yeah?
It's like a giant monster waiting to be awakened.
Yeah.
Did someone
sleeping
say
dragon.
Awoken?
But yeah, no, people can comment. They can comment on the website. They can comment on...
They just haven't.
Like, it's just... We are big in Manitoba. The 80%+ of our downloads come from Manitoba. So anybody in Manitoba who's downloading
Texas,
this, we appreciate. We had Texas, we had California.
So just if you listen to us and you comment, we're going to shout you out on the show.
Oh, totally.
We're going to worship you. We may bronze something in your honor.
Yeah.
Mike will make you coffee.
I'll make a
fresh pot of coffee.
I will make a flaming pyre of remembrance to your comment in the back lane. Like, it'll get epic. So please comment. Please tell us what you think.
Even if you hate it, just
yeah,
tell us.
Yeah, we want some sort of feedback. No feedback, we can't grow. So I would definitely give it like 5 out of 5 Godzillas when it comes to King.
Five out of five.
Wow.
I would. Yeah. No. I didn't. I just.
Wow.
That's pretty good score.
I loved being entertained by it.
Yep.
And I loved the fantasy of it. The plot holes, the missing information, that's just the only critique I can come up with.
We're each going to send Mike a text like later in the night saying, fuck, I want my 2 hours back. That wasn't a 5 out of 5.
But I'm surprised that if you watched the newer Godzilla and Godzilla King of the Monsters, that you didn't know more about the history of kaiju movies from Japan.
I just said Asian was an accent. What do you think? Like, yeah. That literally, that
point,
was a miss.
Point
that
taken.
Was a, yeah, that was a misspeak. But like, I tried to get into that community a couple years ago. It just didn't take. I just don't have.
I watched them all in the '80s.
The
like,
Asian
that when I was a
community?
Kid, right? When I was a kid, that's
what
I watched.
What you're saying?
No, manga and anime, like the where all of this whole podcast that's soon to be coming up comes from.
It all comes from sort of that history of kaiju is monster in Japanese, or daikaiju.
You were saying that
big
outside.
Monster. So that's kind of the history and the way that the movies were filmed, where they use like perspective to create the size of the monsters and not CGI, but they actually use like
little models.
Yeah.
And such. Yeah.
And that was like the history of it. And it was pretty cool the way that was all.
The best was the dude. Oh, it's Godzilla. And then it's one
exactly.
Dude,
right.
Zoom out. Oh, no.
And there's a long history of that. That was pretty cool. That kind of spurred things on. And then my choice for today is like paid homage to the kaiju movies by actually naming the monsters in this.
I can't wait.
In Pacific Rim kaiju.
I can't wait to argue against that. I just want to put a pin in that for like 1 second. And get on to the trailer of the week now.
Which, sorry.
Are we doing trailer or trailers?
Well, it's trailers. You're right. You're right on the pluralification
trailers
of that word.
Trailers.
I challenge all of you to come up with a different beat each week until we find a intro to this.
Trailers.
I really would like to hear what people think of our bringing in of the different clips into the show. Like when you were talking about werewolves last episode. And I put the little howl in. Someone's got just tell me if you think it's shit. That's all I need to know, and I'll make it worth your while.
I like the Rock one you put in with the wrestling. That was funny. I said the Rock, and you're just like, I'm like, oh shit, he played the Rock loop.
Pat my back for that one. Okay, so yeah, the trailers of the week. Let's start with the one we've been waiting for. Like, how long has it been?
What are we doing? All Will Smith all the time.
Will
Smiths.
Yeah, we're getting jiggy with
three
it
Will Smiths.
If your math checks out.
Should I just give my opinion on both quickly?
Yeah, that's exactly where we're going to start.
Well, let's tell them what we're watching.
We watched Bad Boys 3.
Hey! Oh, shit. Oh, come on, man.
You can get that buffed out.
No, you can get that buffed out.
Remember, knock and talk.
Yeah, knock, knock.
Mighty PD, get down! What the hell happened to knock and talk?
Hands behind your head right now.
I got this. I'm gonna penetrate this man's soul with my heart.
What?
Watch and learn.
Sir, I realize that you're scared.
You know, sometimes fear.
How deep you think you got in his soul?
I'm done, Mike. I'm retiring.
Uh-oh, here we go again.
You want your legacy to be muscle shirts and body counts?
Look at this mess, it's carnage!
I didn't do all this.
You didn't shoot anybody?
Well, come on, Cap, you know I shot some people.
Yeah. Fuck me! Fuck!
Bad Boys for Life.
For Life.
Well, it's the third installment in the Bad Boys series.
False advertising. Comes out January 17th, 2020.
Trademarked by Diggy. Diddy.
Diddy.
And we're also doing Gemini Man. So
Gemini.
Tell me something. Why is it so hard for you to kill this man?
He knew every move of mine before I made it. I'd have him right there to take the shot.
I wanna be forever young.
And he'd be gone like a ghost.
Do you really wanna live forever?
Who is he?
I think I know why he's as good as you. He is you.
25 years ago, they made you from me. They chose me because there's never been anybody like me. We have to end this right now.
Yes, Chris, you start first.
We're at the top. I'm more excited for BB3.
BB4L. BB4L.
Yeah, I don't know. It just looks like it carries on the charisma of the second movie. And I guess the first. I haven't seen the first a lot, but I did see the second one a bunch of times. So I'm looking for it looks like a Michael Bay. It is Michael Bayist, right? We're driving through a mall. You're like, oh, Martin.
Yeah, it's like buddy action cop. Yeah,
that's
comedy.
What it is. That's what it is.
Yes,
that's what
it is. Those, it checks those, a lot of boxes.
Those are generally fun, like just a big blast, right?
Yeah, so, you can't go out of it. You can't go into every movie wanting to think about shit. Sometimes you just want to.
So,
like Lethal Weapon.
Yes.
Quickly onto Gemini Man. Not. I don't think I'll even bother seeing it. It comes out next month.
Yep.
I like how it says, like, from visionary director Ang Lee,
yeah.
But it doesn't look striking to me at all, even on an HD TV. I was, like, when they're, like, Life of Pi, like, that Life of Pi is, like, wow.
Yes.
That looked pretty tame.
Did you read the book, Life of Pi, at all?
No.
No? Did anybody else in the room read the book before they watched the movie? Yeah, I, just little sidebar, when I saw Life of Pi, that's one of my favorite books. That's exactly what I imagined. Like, Ang Lee fucking, that was a half-court shot, for sure.
Is Gemini Man based off of a book, or is that just...
I don't know. I don't know.
Will Smith needs four starring credits this year.
He needs a sixth garage in his place in Bel Air.
He probably gets paid for two different roles. He plays two
different
people. If
he really lives in Bel Air, that's fantastic.
Right? He's probably arguing, like, I want $20 million.
Well, he probably gets
$20 million per role.
Yeah.
That's two.
That's... I know Aaron.
40 million.
Oh, Aaron was telling me about John Hamm in the Skip the Dishes commercials.
Yep. Yeah.
Actors will charge astronomical amounts of money so that they don't have to eat or do things repetitively. Like, they're just like, hey, it's 20 million if you want me to eat, and it's 5 million just if I'm going to do the commercial. And no company in their right mind is going to be like, 20 million for a guy to eat food? We're not paying that. So that's how they, like, get out of it. So to what you're saying about...
What do you mean, eat food? What are you talking about?
Okay,
food?
So John Hamm in the Skip the Dishes commercials.
Yeah.
Doesn't eat at all. Like, he doesn't...
He's just there.
Talks about it.
But if Skip says, hey, we want you to eat in the commercial, he's like, okay, it's another 25 million.
Okay.
And that's how actors get away with not doing things. They just find it's too much money. So I wonder if Will Smith used that to his benefit, where he's like, you have two of me, so you got to pay for double. Right, that's the those little loopholes.
And maybe that's why the rest of the movie just looks kind of flat. I don't know.
They spent all the budget on Will Smith.
I'll give you a buy one, get one half off.
That's two Will Smiths for the price of one. Well,
and they're definitely showing off that make older actors look young technology. That
the new
really
CGI tech. Yeah.
They obviously did it for Will Smith.
I think they should have employed some of that on Bad Boys with Martin Lawrence.
No, but I like it. I like that.
I like that. He's older now. He's retiring.
Number Two came out 16 years ago. Yeah. So.
I honestly, when they started that, I'm like, why is Martin Lawrence in a fat suit? That's not.
I
got
agree.
Them cheeks. You got what? Them cheeks.
So I'm a...
Like this, the clumps.
My final comment, Gemini Man, because I don't think it looks good. There's an early part in the trailer. Will Smith says, like, he knew my every move before I ever did it or whatever.
Yeah.
And then the following shot is him being like throwing like a motorcycle sort of at him off like the as he's chasing him, but it hits something else. Like, he didn't actually have to dodge it, kind of deal.
That was bad editing.
Yeah, it was bad. It was like, oh no, they should have shown like where he takes a punch and blocks it or something, which is maybe kind of like, oh, he blocked it. But that would have been
every punch.
He just keeps dodging everything.
I thought that exact same thing. I'm like, the motorcycle just hit the wall.
Yeah,
like,
yeah. All he did was just duck. But he kind of had it too, because it hit like a tank or something. It looked like.
Or did he know my thought was like, he knew he was a clone. That's why he didn't want to kill him.
Well, we're led to believe
that's why he's like, I'm just gonna scare him.
Those two scenes are chronological.
So
yeah, I don't know. I don't even know who was attacking who in that. But just the way the wording was, and then what you see, it's like, the guy
just different.
Yeah, he just dodged it easily.
he
didn't
have
to. Anyways, that was just a nitpick.
It's a bad edit in a trailer.
So
for sure,
BBFL.
BBFL for life.
Yeah.
Bad Boys for life. Mark, what do you think?
I'm gonna. You know what? Bad Boys excites me because I love the original Bad Boys.
Yeah.
Bad Boys 2 was good. Like the characters, like Martin Lawrence.
Mike Lowry. Remember that over?
I use that so much because I know a guy with the last name Lowry. And his name's Sean, but I'm always like, I'm Mike Lowry. Every time I see him, I'm like, that's not my first name. It's so, and Martin Lawrence is good. He was, he, like...
Martin, I'm the man.
It's funny. He's like Well, I watched Central Intelligence not long ago. And oh my goodness. I like Central Intelligence was kind of like a playoff of Bad Boys. Like
they were totally riding the
which
wave.
Which one's this?
That's with like The Rock and
Kevin Hart.
Kevin Hart, right?
Yep.
And like Martin Lawrence was Kevin Hart before Kevin Hart was around. Like Martin Lawrence was the funny little make fun of himself black dude. And
100%.
I think I like Martin Lawrence better than I like Kevin Hart.
I couldn't.
And I haven't seen Martin Lawrence in very much stuff in a long time, and I like him a lot.
You know, he's
Blue
definitely.
Blue Streak is a classic.
Blue Streak is awesome. Yeah. What was that one with Tim Robbins? Nothing to Lose. Nothing to Lose with Tim Robbins. That was good, too.
Oh, yeah.
He's good. Yeah. I like him a lot.
That was all part of the TBS collection.
Martin Lawrence plays uncomfortable really well.
He does. Woosah. Woosah.
So I'm hoping. I don't know if the trailer got me super stoked on the movie. In particular, but the fact that they're coming out with a Bad Boys 3, Bad Boys for Life, remembering the old movies, I'm like, I'm going to go watch it. Even if you just told me that and didn't show me a trailer, I want to see it.
Yeah. I
Gemini Man, I'm not going to go to the movie theater to see it. It looks interesting. I really like the trailer for trailer quality because they did, other than the shitty editing on the one that Chris mentioned, the song. I don't know if you guys were listening when they
Forever
did
Young.
Like a really
it's a cover of it, yeah.
cool cover of Forever yeah. Young.
Forever Young.
Yeah. It was cool. I like when they really mess with a cover or something, and it was cool. It was nice.
Disturbed did a haunting cover recently of, what is it? All right, hang on here.
Sound of Silence?
Sound of Silence, Simon and Garfunkel. Have you guys heard this?
I don't think I have.
I'll play it for you after the show. It's one of... he's clearly tamed down his look, but he still has those three spikes coming out of his like a goatee of spikes.
Yeah,
and he's just digging so deep in nails. It's great. To your point that you know new covers
the song was almost unrecognizable.
It was lyrically. It's
when I picked up. Oh,
that's
like,
the way I like covers. I don't like someone who covers it and just sings it in the exact same medley.
So,
do something different.
So sorry, you liked the Forever Young.
I liked
thing?
It. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, no, I agree.
I didn't even really notice cool. it. I got to listen to it later.
Yeah, I picked up on it, and one line I'm like, is this Forever, like the cover of the song Forever Young? And then the next line I'm like, oh, yeah.
Martin, what'd you think?
I'm in the same boat. I'm going to watch Bad Boys for sure. I don't know. I was just a huge fan of the original, like everyone else. I when we were talking about it, I just remembered, oh, man, Taya Leone was like the leading lady in Bad Boys 1.
Oh, yeah.
So I was just like, that's how long ago.
I didn't notice that there was a leading lady in this one. They didn't really
showcase anything.
Vanessa Hudgens, she's not in the trailer because this is probably the teaser trailer, and then we'll have the
actual trailer.
I won't watch that one because that'll give way too much of a movie like this, I feel.
Yeah.
You'll see all the biggest action set pieces, and you're like, okay.
Well, and like it's assumed that through two movies we've seen Martin Lawrence is, you know, loyal to his wife and Mike Lowry is a playboy. So we can imagine that we'll probably see Will Smith's character Mike
wasn't
Lowry.
He dating,
it's been
he was
flipped
dating
this
his sister.
Time,
he
really?
Wasn't he dating
I,
his sister?
I don't know. I'm guessing. Oh, okay. That's the new twist.
I would
the
love
second
to
one.
Yeah.
He was dating wasn't he interested in
the
Martin
union
Lawrence's
of
sister?
The Union of Gabriels was dating Gabriel Union was Martin Lawrence's
the
Gaug.
Gaug.
The, all of them.
Sorry,
all of them.
Gaug was
Will Smith's character, right?
Was dating Will Smith's character, but that was Martin
Lawrence.
Maybe Martin Lawrence will like end up with Will Smith's mom or something.
Something weird. Yeah,
something. Come downstairs in a.
I like. What did he decide? The captain was really cool. Joe Pantaleone.
Yeah.
He's like his outbursts are fantastic.
My favorite scene was when he was shooting ball. And just missing. And then Will Smith gives one. Everyone will be like Mike. And I was like, oh, yeah, everyone be like Mike.
He might be one of my favorite captains or like boss. Like there's the scenes in movies all the time, right, where you like go into the boss's office. So
the
it's either
off
like
captain.
The captain, the editor, the newspaper who's losing it on you. Like one, and he might be one of my favorite.
The pissed off cop captain.
Yeah. Ice Cube was really good in 21 Jump Street.
Yeah, he was. Yeah. You just gave him props for fucking your daughter. Who, and I was like, oh, damn.
Who? One of the guys from... the black cop in Chips. Did you guys see Chips?
Yep.
Yeah.
He did a really good job giving shit to his yoga pant obsessed.
Michael Pena.
Michael Pena, who just walks around LA checking out yoga pant ass all day long.
Yes. So I like that scene, and Joe Pantaleone was really good.
I am also looking forward to Bad Boys for Life very much. That was one of those movies that. I know for certain that when I was like forced to go out to my father's on the weekend, like I know that movie cold, right? Like you put that on and I can you know, start playing along with the lines and, you know, the timing. Like, it's just a very well played movie for me. But their relationship is amazing. You were right, Mark. Like, dude buddy comedy kind of role.
Yeah.
With big blow up action. Michael Bay just, it's like, all right, every scene is going to have, you know, nitro in it and some sort of thing hitting a thing, blowing up over a thing. A lot of fire, right? So, yeah, Gemini Man, the more I watch it, the more interested I am in it.
Yeah.
I have started to give it a little bit, because I liked Looper. And
I did like Looper.
This has the same feeling of Looper, where present self meets past self.
But what I liked with Looper, though, it was Bruce Willis versus
Joseph Gordon-Levitt.
I kind of like that. This is just literally Will Smith trying to out-act Will Smith.
I didn't like the CGI. That bugged me. His face, like the young, like it bugged me.
That cheekbone was too defined for me. Like, he looked like he had an exoskeleton underneath it. It's...
Well, maybe that's the twist.
I was just going to say, maybe the twist
that's,
is one of them
that's
is a robot.
That's the Gemini program.
I'm a Dominator.
Right?
Yeah. The Gemini program?
It's
yeah,
the Gemini program, and then you'll discover, and they take down the organization, yeah, right?
There'll be an S, like Genesis.
Yeah.
Like Terminator Genesis. Something like that. What? No, I'm just kidding.
I don't need to go
see it. It'll set up the expanded universe. It'll be like Aquarius Man.
They'll hope that they'll have the Aquarius
Leo Boy. Come here, Leo Boy.
The Zodiac Corporation.
Yeah. Cancer person.
Hi, I'm Pisces.
Sagittarius.
Yeah, this is huge.
They're hoping that they stumble upon a John Wick, right? Because I think
I guess, but
I feel though that John Wick is the new mold where everybody's like trying to make some sort of action series, because obviously there's money in it.
Yeah,
because John Wick was on nobody's radar, and it's a fucking fantastic action movie. It's got some great humor. The plot's great. Angry retired hitman comes back because his wife is dead, and someone took his dog and his car. Like, that is not something you bring.
Someone killed his dog.
Just killed his dog and took his car.
That's the big part.
It's got some humor, and I think that's that action movies lost humor for a little while. Like, Bad Boys was the era of like the jokey, like you blow shit up and you laugh and it's like nobody's, it's not serious.
You cause so much chaos.
And some of them forgot that. Like, some of the series kind of forgot that. Like, you're, like a lot of the, what's the one with,
Die Hard.
Die Hard had comedy. But the, like, ones like Jack Reacher and those kind of things weren't really comedic.
No, you know, were these charming, brooding, dark men with a past.
That's always been kind of Tom Cruise's thing. His movies have never really been comedic.
Yeah, who's the other guy that can't remember who he is?
Jason Statham.
Vin
Diesel.
Dominic Toretto.
Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
Paul Walker. Shut up. But I like the comedy, and I think a lot of movies have discovered that people like a healthy dose of comedy with
brevity.
Action. Yeah. That's why like Thor Ragnarok did so well compared to like Thor the Dark World, because there's a lot more humor in Ragnarok, and we like our action with a healthy dose of humor. Which Bad Boys is going to give us. Gemini Man doesn't look like it's going to give us that dose of humor, so I don't know if I'm going to like it as much.
I'm going to need some medication to feel better after one of them. All right, cool. Moving on. Now, time for that the thing. Where's the music? Come on, someone make some noise. Mm-hmm. There it is.
Okay. Ding, 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 ding. I'm this corner.
I have that. I've tried out all these sound effects. But anyways, yeah, now it's time.
Weighing in at 165 pounds, hailing from Manila, Philippines, Martin Navarro.
It's actually 155, Mark.
Navarro.
Are you 155?
Yeah.
All right.
My fighting weight's 132, though.
Fuck off.
Yeah. I'm not dieting right now, so.
I've seen your Instagram feed. I know what you're eating on a weekly basis.
Yeah.
All right, let's get into this debate. I totally took over this episode of the podcast from my idea, but I've been playing this one, with this one for a while, and it resurfaced after watching Godzilla King of Monsters, because I have professed in the past that I do think Dwayne The Rock Johnson is one of the best, if not the best, current action actor in Hollywood. Except he
was
broke.
Was that who you were thinking of?
No, that's not who I was thinking of when I thought of this.
Mark Wahlberg?
Yay, running joke.
Yeah, it's going to come back later. It's going to come back.
I really disliked Rampage. I thought it was a bad...
The video game? No, it was awesome.
The video game was amazing, which is why I was looking forward to Rampage so much. And then I realized it's very hard to take a video game that all you're doing is just jumping on buildings and killing other large animals.
No, there's still a way to make it good.
They missed it, is my point.
Okay.
Right? So, but it's the wrong studio did it. So yeah, it was great. We had the giant lizard. We had the giant werewolf.
Did all three of them show up?
All three of them show up. Okay. Yeah,
I can't remember if I saw that in the trailer or not.
They tried to give it too much of a story though, didn't they?
That's what I'm saying. Is that
I couldn't finish it. I tried to watch it. I couldn't watch all of it.
It let me down. And so I thought, what would be a great idea though for the podcast is if we looked at every great monster from sci-fi movies and created our own Rampage to make up for the lack of Rampage that happened in Rampage, which is
wasn't near enough Rampage.
Not enough Rampage.
But this is also us battling.
Exactly.
You guys.
It's a four-way battle inspired by.
Because that's how I wrote it.
Yes. No, you're right. You're right. Yeah. You're totally right. I can get off track. So it's inspired by that idea where the four of us are pitted against each other in XYZ place. We pick our monster and we argue off why our monster would kick ass, essentially. So without further bullshitting from me, Chris, you drew short of straw. So why don't you take us into your world and your idea of who you'd bring to the fight?
Okay, well, did you mention the scale thing to scale?
Yes, no, it is.
It doesn't really, you know, well, yeah. I honestly
no,
don't
we
really
all
should,
fight
yeah,
the same
yeah,
side.
It'll be, yeah, it'll be, to be notes, honest, yeah. Really with my, I have it or Pennywise to the
bullshit.
With the masses. But the scale thing?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, it doesn't you really thought matter.
Well,
I still have it. So yeah.
we said we would take to scale. We said that powers transposed from the movie into the fight, so you weren't limited in any way, shape, or form, and
just whatever the character is just exists. Okay, so it, I don't know. It doesn't have to be any sort of city, but I'm fighting all three of you guys. But yeah, I chose it from the movie It, and this is part one, not the Tim Curry movie. Didn't really matter. It's probably the same character.
Hiya, Georgie. What a nice boat. Do you want it back?
Yes, please.
You look like a nice boy. I bet you have a lot of friends.
Three, but my brother's my best guess.
Where is he?
In bed, sick.
I bet I could cheer him up. I'll give him a balloon. Do you want a balloon too, Georgie?
I'm not supposed to take stuff from strangers.
Oh, well, I'm Pennywise, the dancing clown. Pennywise? Yes, meet Georgie. Georgie, meet Pennywise. Now we aren't strangers, are we?
For those that don't know, so basically, for those that don't know, yeah. Like, most people, when they think of it, they think of the clown, right? But I'm not going with that. I'm going with the actual ancient
like
cosmic
the
being.
Being,
yeah, yeah. Like the to be all sort of cosmic being. That's the one I'm going there. One of its main things, its powers, is that it feeds off the fear of its victims, and then it kind of naps for like 27 years. Yeah, so it goes that. So that's my main power, and I was like, how? What is everyone's fear that I could feed off of? Right. So that's where I went with this. Just let me get, I have a list. It's important. Okay, yeah. So Alien Queen, right, Martin? It was the Alien Queen.
I'm Hellboy.
Yeah.
I'm Hellboy.
Oh, you're Hellboy.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah, spoiler alert.
who had Alien Queen? Okay.
Okay, for posterity, let's just name everything so that everybody knows who's fighting who. You bring up a very good point. You're totally right, because normally we do it where we surprise everybody, but for this debate, it actually...
He has a strategy.
It does need to be
spoken. I got
to
go through each one of you.
Totally, I understand. So I, Michael, picked the Alien Queen from the Alien series. Martin, who'd you pick?
Hellboy.
Perfect. And Mark, who did you pick?
I picked the large class 5 Kaiju Slattern from the end of the first Pacific Rim movie.
Quick question about Slattern. They didn't show up back in the second one, right?
He was killed off.
They probably had a different kind of Kaiju, whatever that
is. There's lots
called.
Of different kinds of Kaijus, yes.
There's a comic too, right?
Good question.
I'm just kind of, I was like having to read up because I only saw Pacific one. I saw both of them and I was just reading. I'm like, fuck, I want to get more into this universe. I don't know if they'll ever be another.
Yeah, movie. I found Uprising the second one just went like, I don't know.
To me, it
went like
that
full
one.
Power Rangers.
Yeah, you know what? I didn't mind that.
Red
I didn't mind
or
that.
Thunder Power.
I could not finish the second one at all.
Yeah, it was
awesome. I appreciate it. I wanted to support it just in case we could get maybe more of it. Who knows? Maybe.
The cool thing, and I'll talk about it, the Kaiju are kind of like a force, right? They're from another dimension.
Yeah, have a hive mind.
They create the Kaiju based on the like what beats them, then they create a kaiju to beat what beat them, right? So they're creating these monsters.
Oh, so they're ever evolving.
Yeah, so when one of the Jaegers beats a kaiju, like if it beats it with its new like electric pulse, then they create a kaiju that's now that is anti-electric, that can now battle. So it's like a hive mind that creates these monsters based on what they've lost in the past.
It's giant Borg.
Yeah.
All right, so Chris, how would you go through us here?
Okay, so my first opponent is I take on the Alien Queen.
Right, Michael.
Right here.
Oh, yeah.
Over here.
Hi. Michael, hi. The Alien Queen, Petra.
Yeah. Yeah.
would be my fighting name if I was getting called down to the ring.
I wanted to take on the Alien Queen because to me this was the easiest one.
Fuck you.
Just because... At the end of the day, the Alien Queen is just basically a parasite, large parasite.
I have two
whatever
fucking pages on the Alien Queen. She's not just nothing.
In but the movies, she's just nothing.
She is basically, in the end, flesh and exoskeleton shit, whatever all that stuff all right, is.
Yeah, fine.
So, right, so she can still be controlled. But what's her greatest fear is fire.
Yes, this is true.
Basically, it would just surround her with fire all the time. It wouldn't even have to
wait
be real.
Wait a minute, Chris, are you talking, you're going to mind fuck the Alien Queen?
I am. Just give her all the burning sensation. She couldn't escape. And all the meanwhile, the whole time, I don't know, Pennywise would show up and just be like, hiya, Queenie. And then be like, yeah, take that.
Is that it?
Okay. I think, it was easy. Hiya, like, it was all just right. Burn, and like, you just burn the alien, make her think that she's burning alive.
Yeah, it is intense heat or, that, or
because,
fire.
Because basically the Alien Queen is an apex predator and all she's taking on is humans. Now that she's taking on
other apex predators.
Yeah, like beyond an apex predator. Now it's like gods kind of.
How does that translate to the screen? Like what do you look like on the screen?
Me?
Yeah.
Well, it would be the fire. Because it would be the fire
so,
that's
so
the
like
fear.
When if we are on like four corners of this battle, what does your corner look like right now?
I think
like if I'm filling a red balloon.
I think there's lots.
It's the red balloon. Like, hey,
is a sewer grate with a red balloon hanging?
It's
on
kind
it?
Of almost in a way whatever you need wanna me to swimming. Be. I think
wanna
in that scenario.
That,
you, but sound, initial... you sound like a Russian hooker.
Yeah. That's good. That's good. But you can ask me that when it's your turn.
Touche.
I just want to know how it looks on the TV.
No, I get it. You want to picture it in your mind. Yeah. Your mind's eye. Okay.
Well, again, it versus the alien would just be basically fire. That's all you'd be seeing.
So
if
to
you
the
saw
alien,
it
would be fire. When the alien looks
like
at
the alien
corner.
Would see fire. It's kind of like how in the movies it's not just Pennywise is what people are afraid of. Like, you know,
Pennywise is their worst fear. So
yeah,
he
but they can still manipulate it so other things freak you out, right? Yeah. So maybe this would in this case the alien would be fire.
I get what he's saying. I'd run.
The alien would be like, what the fuck is going on? Like, it's just fire. I understand.
Fire.
So, ding, alien down. Okay, so I saved what I found to be the hardest one second. And that's,
please say Hellboy.
And that's the kaiju. Just because I didn't, I was doing research on the kaiju or Slattern. Is that
Slattern was
Slattern?
The
that's
only
the one
class
you,
five.
Yeah, that's kaiju. The one you're kind of going with, right? Yes. Yeah. Okay. So I was trying to figure out what its weakness is, and to me, it was just
not much.
Just it's just a big beast, really. Like it gets killed by a thermal bomb or something. I think in the or some.
A
I was like, did
blast.
They stab?
Yeah, two but nuclear
I,
blasts.
But I was like, that's not. It's not afraid of that, right? So I was trying to look up like what would. That kind of thing be afraid of.
It
so,
doesn't have fear.
Well, this is where.
Here we go.
Yeah, this is what I had. Okay,
what,
so
what would Slattern see in your corner?
fear is a human
yeah,
emotion.
Yeah, so what does the kaiju or
yes,
Slattern
human
fear most?
Emotion.
So there's two things. The first, the kaiju is an intelligent, it's intelligent, right?
Yes.
That's sentient.
Yeah, it has. It's an intelligent being. It's also another apex kind of predator. It fears, you know, being taken over, and it fears Godzilla. Hear me out, because that's the actual king of kaiju. So you would turn into Godzilla and be like, yo, check out my hyper beam. and that would probably just tear through that kaiju, and then you can do your own little like, oh, we learned the lesson now. Again, Godzilla wins every time. It's King is in the nickname, King of the Monsters.
I
so,
like it.
So the other reason is that they would fear, I always pronounce his name wrong, Idris Elba.
Idris Elba.
Did I say it right?
Regress Elba?
Idris. Elba. Mr. Elba, he would fear him. Not just because he's a physical threat, because he can control the Jaegers and all that. Not because of that. Because that would mean that the Kaiju is now in just kind of like a mediocre modern day B movie, and it's not going to go well for the Kaiju in like nerd culture lore. That's my second point for the Kaiju. Because the thing is, like, Pacific Rim, yeah, great, first movie, and then the second movie, it's already sort of getting away from the public eye, and there's nothing worse than dying and everyone forgetting who you are. So.
Yeah, sure enough. It's better to burn out than it is to fail.
Exactly. Away. So Elba represents that with, you know, like, the third Star Trek movie, Dark Tower, probably the new Fast and Furious. You know, it's just outside the Thor movies, he's struggling, I feel, so.
I love Idris Elba.
Yeah, me too. But he stars in mediocre crap.
Oh.
He's going to be Bond. I'm making that call right now. I'm putting that out into the world.
What was he in those last? That was good. There was something. I just can't remember.
No, Next Bond. He was
great
in
Hobbs and Shaw.
Next Bond is female.
You think so?
Yeah.
He'll go female. Okay. All right.
So lastly was Hellboy. Where did it go?
Oh, it's gone. How convenient.
Oh, yeah, here it is. So for Hellboy, I take it you went with the Ron Perlman?
Yeah. Okay. I'll explain why.
And also you guys wanted to know the connection between your three movies is Ron Perlman. So there you go.
Oh, yeah. He was in all three.
Oh, yeah. Alien Resurrection.
Yep.
Yeah.
You were close with Del Toro. I was going to say close, but I was like, oh, no. If I say close, then you guys will start thinking of actors.
Yeah.
So no, I just was like, nope.
That is really interesting, yeah. Plays basketball with Ellen Ripley.
So yeah, yours is Hellboy. So what I would show, you'd have Hellboy. He probably fights Satan, I'm sure, or God
fights
himself.
Demons.
Yeah, he fights demons. He's a tough cookie to crack, you know. But I saved him last because I felt what we would do, it would just turn itself into like a studio executive, who has no idea why the first two were kind of popular amongst its fan base. So it would just create another quick cash grab. He would show Ron Perlman Hellboy this, which would just be absolutely terrifying. Like, what have you done to my boy? Once Hellboy accepts this reality, then transform into the box office numbers for Hellboy 2019, and that would just be it.
I like that. That's funny. That was good. You took like down the fourth wall, and you just. I love that. That was. And
that's kind of what.
That's a fun argument.
Does, right?
That's a fun argument.
I completely agree with you, Martin.
I didn't expect that. I thought you were gonna.
He's coming from a different angle.
He definitely is.
I thought you were gonna turn into like the girl he was interested in the
movie.
But I'm like, oh, well,
I'll be
that's
honest.
Too
I haven't seen Hellboy in a really long time, and
yeah. Well, he has a love interest, right? So then I thought you were
turning. Is that what he's afraid of? Though?
Losing her.
Oh, okay. Because
they have like she's pregnant in the second one.
I could have gone down that road where you just show him.
But I'm glad you didn't because I like the way you did it. That's I never saw that coming. I was like, that's good. That's good.
Thank you.
I was impressed.
All right.
When you said you had a strategy, I'm like, okay, I thought it was going to be predictable. Like, his obviously was predictable, but like
who are you pointing at me?
You're like it fired. That I'm like it's going to be.
Oh, that is your weak. Like, that is what you're
the
afraid
weakness,
of.
The weakness.
That's why I started.
Yeah.
Kaiju was my. I struggled that one. I was still working on that one on the way over here. I was like, I don't know.
That was good. You took
are you afraid of giant swords?
You took us at an angle that I didn't expect.
Charlie Day's acting.
Does anybody? Because the only thing I'm trying to poke a hole in is that when you're not your all-encompassing giant entity as Pennywise, I don't, like, is it safe to assume that you're as strong as Pennywise as you are as your it character? Because I
feel
like...
Well, the thing is, it's really tough to beat me with the characters you picked because you're not all 10-year-old children wanting to have a sex orgy, so I am good to go. Unless you guys want to have that with your characters, then you guys are good to go.
I mean, it's a great entertaining argument, and I'm more impressed with the entertainment value than I thought I would be. So
it feels good to have a good debate. I've
struggled
with
my
last few ones.
That was
so
a good one.
Bad.
No, that's a good solid approach. Mark, you wanna
you look like you have something to say.
I don't know how it translates to the screen. I don't know what it looks like.
It turns from Rampage into a comedy.
That's right. But what I was describing is
like
what
in
you
a,
would
in
see.
In a book, in a book, it might be good, but I don't know if it translates
have
to
you,
the big
but
screen.
But have you seen the? You haven't seen the movie.
I haven't seen the movie.
You have?
No, I haven't.
See, so I don't know
I'm a little. I'm
so
a little
what,
out of
what,
it. I understand the concept.
What
right?
what I'm, they from, see, like what is you're seeing on screen, is what is still it. but he's or it is
what
you, is what showing the them their sees, what the character sees.
He's basically giving them
that's
hallucinations.
It, yeah. Yeah. He's yeah. He's scarecrowing you, if it gives you any idea, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
So
well, exactly, but I'm just what there's no physical manifestation of it.
Well, no, it like, manifests.
Like Chris, Chris is not picking a physical manifestation of it for this showdown.
No.
So it's just like a blank, like when they're well, showing no, the pictures no, of because, who's in this battle. It's just a it, blank window.
No, because
is that what we're getting here?
No, because it.
I
is,
am what you want me to be, big boy.
It can transform into self. Into different things.
I just don't think it translates good for the remake of Rampage.
Oh, and you're very welcome to that opinion.
It's going to be our three monsters and then a red balloon. In the
back. And that's scary what it's going to be. Fuck.
Three monsters and a red balloon.
All right. Well,
that's the poster.
99 red balloons.
Let me turn this up a bit.
If that's
here
what scares you.
With my
bad German pop.
A studio executive showing Ron Perlman's future.
My one thing about yours, Chris, is that you did get beat by like 10-year-old kids. That's it.
Yeah.
But I love the argument. I love the argument that you got beat by 10-year-old kids is my only point.
The thinking outside the box, I have to give props to.
Yeah, that was good.
But did they beat it, or did they beat the Pennywise kind of portion?
I guess
that
they beat Pennywise.
Right.
Or do they beat their own fear?
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
isn't Pennywise fear manifested?
That's how you
right?
beat it. Is because if you're not afraid of it anymore, then that's how you beat him.
Yeah.
Because you're just not scared.
His
fear doesn't, he feeds off your fear, right? So if you can't feed off your fear, if you're not giving anything, then he loses.
This classic horror movie is now getting really meta.
Yeah.
Like it.
I read about it too. I read about like some of his powers too before it came down. And yeah, that's how he does it.
So
that's why, I guess in the end, right? The kids weren't scared anymore. So then they're just like,
yeah, they fought back.
We're going to fight back now.
Yeah.
That's how there's a sequel, I guess.
The more you know. Well, no, the sequel is the original movie is all in itself. They're just breaking these apart to make money, right? But the original.
Well, the sequel's now that 27 years later, I assume.
That's,
and now it's the adults.
Exactly.
Them as adults.
I'm going to say, like, really good cast. Really good cast. Like, all-star
like
cast.
3 hours, I hear.
It's.
Like, what's her name's in it?
Jessica Chastain.
Chastain's
Bill Hader.
In it.
Bill Hader.
And the. Professor X.
Professor.
Oh, really?
Oh,
yeah. He's
James McAvoy.
James McAvoy. He's one of the. He's the kid who looks in the grate. I think in the.
Oh, Charlie.
I think so.
Like the little brother.
The missing brother.
Because in the trailer it shows him staring at the grate. In the trailer it shows him looking in the grate. So he must have known.
Well, that could be it manifesting itself, which pisses Mark off. I shake my head. I shake my kaiju fist at you.
Well, I think I went over my 10 minutes.
That's okay. We weren't even. Was anybody keeping track? I'm timing on us here. We're right on schedule. Okay, Mike. Yes. Okay.
Alien Queen Petro.
Alien.
No, we're calling him Gimbal.
Gimbal.
Gimbal, you have the floor. 10
Thank
minutes.
You. All right. Okay, so I picked the Alien Queen.
From her, you bitch!
And I do have a slight strategy. I realize that you're probably going to relate this to my flailing situation where I think one zombie comes at me at a time. But so the reason I picked the Alien Queen is there's a couple reasons, but the major one is her. Well, I'll do what Chris did. I'll go in order here. So I look at it manifested as fear or as Pennywise, and I look at Hellboy, and I'm 20 feet tall. The Alien Queens range from 15 to 20 feet.
But we're all to size.
You are. But no. If you're to size and I compare Pennywise, like I'm going after Pennywise in clown form, because if Pennywise is in like fear form, creating him like being a little campfire in the corner, scaring the shit out of me. I'm coming at you when you're in your clown shape, which is, let's say, what, 6 feet tall at worst.
But I would argue I would never be in my clown shape because I knew that wouldn't bother you.
You're seeing what bothers you.
I know. But from my perspective, if I'm going into a fight, I'm not anticipating
you're just gonna see
that.
Fire.
Well, no, I'm. But
I'm not. You could say that you're like more mentally strong that the fire doesn't bother you because you can tell that it's not real.
Yeah, but well, and Alien Queens are.
You're welcome, by the way.
No, but no, I didn't. But I didn't present. I'm not presenting my attack.
Here's
base.
A silver. Here's a silver bullet. The only thing that can defeat me. But don't tell anyone.
Anyways, vote for me at the end, please.
No, but I didn't form my my debate based on knowing that you're fire now, right? Like, I formed my debate.
Okay.
So from my perspective, I'm going, okay, I'm going to attack him when he's in Pennywise form, not based on what you've just said, but just how I thought I would do it. So you're a 6 foot clown at worst, and let's say Hellboy's what, 10 feet tall? Did you spec him?
I could spec him while you're
doing it. Okay, yeah, spec him, just see. But I know I'm 20 feet, so, and I've got a 30 to 40 foot tail that's got some serious blades on the end of it. So I'm keeping the both of you at distance because A, I spit acid, and B, you can't get close to me because of my tail. I also am the strongest of all the xenomorphs. Like, the queen has an extra set of arms that are, from what I read on fandom and everything else, are designed for ripping things apart, like when they rip apart David, and when
a xenomorph is just a categorization. Yes. That's not really their race.
Yeah, right? There's spitters, there's drones.
Oh no, a xenomorph means just a being that we have no class. Like it's a different thing than human. It's not human. So
I didn't write down the classification.
A xenomorph
number,
just means
but,
an alien that we can't identify. Like it's something that we can't classify.
Yeah, very much so.
And not human.
An unidentified
human.
Flailing object. If
yes.
You will.
There you go. There you go.
There it fucking is. So I'm flailing my tail around. I'm keeping you guys at bay. You get close, I'm either going to rip you to shreds or I'm going to spit acid on you, and you're going to melt, right? Like, those are really good distance measures.
How do you get close?
Well, I don't have to get close. I just have to keep you far away.
He's got a gun.
I got a gun.
I know you got a gun, but...
Oh, yeah, your gun. Your witch. Your gun.
And I can conjure fire and lightning.
Yeah, no,
I don't know.
But hang on.
I'm going to see some argument, but...
They're okay, in movie, I can prove it in the movies. Okay, fire, yes, definite weakness. We know that from Alien, right? When she uses the flamethrower.
She got scared.
But I don't know if you know this. My exoskeleton that the queen climbs into goes over the head and goes over the chest. It goes over the head and it creates...
But she gets out of that.
Hang on. She goes into her cocoon to create other alien beings.
The eggs.
But she can leave the cocoon
yeah.
to attack. So she's covered in an exoskeleton that can take heavy fire. We've seen it. We've seen it in Alien versus Predator.
But it was enough... Like, that flamethrower was enough to, like, make her not
but
leave.
But see, now if you argue me and you invent a flamethrower, which we've never seen Hellboy use, you can't attack me because you don't have any
flame. I got a
flame.
Gun.
You have a gun, but I can take
and
fire.
And I got the big... I'll do my argument.
Okay, you do.
I can... Your exoskeleton is not going to... Yeah, it's...
But no, it's the only thing that can pierce through is steel rounds. So that be said, I can take heavy fire.
What about silver bullets?
How tall was Hellboy?
Sorry,
but a wooden stake to the heart.
Yeah.
7 feet.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so I've got 13 feet on you, right? So
this is a game you don't want to start playing.
Yeah, Mike, you should just take a knee.
No. This is my favorite part.
No, wait. No, I love this part.
I have assumed the heel position. I'm fine with this.
Because he hasn't done a kaiju yet.
Yeah, so. No, that's kind of...
I don't even want to start giving you my stats
you know what?
Yet.
I
and really, your argument against me is I ignore you.
I'm going to fight the other guys and hope I can hit something.
The only way I really thought, like, and it's a war of attrition. It's not so much like if we were like
war of attrition.
What the hell are you talking about?
Hang on here.
He's gonna hide in a building. Well, and be like, I'm gonna wait till these guys.
Are you the camper of this death match?
Yeah, he's in GoldenEye the temple. Go ahead, hit the body armor. Just
the alien doesn't have a sniper.
Yeah,
are you going to Montreal to hang out in strip clubs till the rest of the gun fighting? Okay.
Yeah. No. Definitely.
Like I said, he's taking the knee.
I've realized that
I don't need to win. I just don't need to lose.
In my fucking opinion, in my humble opinion, I don't really have too much worry. I'm not saying you're not formidable opponents, Pennywise and Hellboy, but we all know who's the fucking kaiju in the room, right? So the only way I
that's
thought
offensive to elephants, by the way.
The only way I thought I could is that if I could hide for long enough, queens lay. Hang on, queens lay 15 eggs.
Please, Mark, just end him. Yeah. Step on him or whatever.
Queens lay 15 eggs an hour.
It's a bug. Just hit it with a boot.
Okay. What's your argument with the eggs, though? That you have an army?
That I have a potential army to start making while this is happening. So if I've got a retreat,
how long are you hiding out in the bush there, Dexter?
That was the only reason I knew this argument really wouldn't like fly. Was
we agreed
like,
no ops. But wait, we agreed no ops.
Like I did the math on it, and in the first 24 hours, it's like 360 eggs, which have to mature. We have to have the face.
How long do they take to mature?
I couldn't find
7 years.
Like I no. Well, no. Hang on.
27 years.
Hey, we know over the course of a 2-hour movie that the alien grows within at least 15 fucking minutes. We're led to believe that. So
that's true.
We can assume that
that's a couple hours.
The maturation of these species, as long as the face sucker gets out. So the only way I know that I can come at the kaiju is to time out and make a bunch of fucking alien face sucker eggs.
That's not gonna happen.
And hope for the fucking best. I realized
this was like Steve's argument with Herbie in the race. Is like, I'm just gonna hide out while everyone else kills everybody. I'm like, that.
No, that was your argument. He was gonna fly.
He said no one's gonna target Herbie. You can't fly. We couldn't fly in the Herbie argument.
There's autonomous vehicle.
He said he was just gonna like make everyone else kill each other at the start. Yeah. I'm like, the start is gonna have the most destruction. How is Herbie gonna do that?
That was your argument.
No, my argument was I'm gonna peace out. You guys can win. I don't care about winning in this one. That's what I said. You're going to hide. Like, that's what Steve's argument. He's going to hide.
You literally said hide in a building.
You can't. You're not going to hide in this.
Is that what an alien queen would do? Would she cower away like that?
In my fight, the kaiju, in my situation.
The kaiju's not fired, so she's not scared of it.
I guess if Mike's controlling the alien queen, I mean, like we were controlling him with controllers, he'd be like, oh, I'll go over here.
Yeah. Well, no, there is also obvious reference where Ellen or not it's not Ellen when they're gonna burn the eggs
in Ellen one Ripley.
I know it's but it's not Ellen Ripley in the scene they're gonna burn the eggs in a scene and she calls off all the drones like they can communicate right like raptor like minds so that's what I was
what
hoping
raptor like minds mean
like a velociraptor like a hive mentality
that's
right
a, what's, that's the raptor. Mentality.
What's the gestation period of one of those eggs
we're assuming 15 minutes for the sake of this argument because
you know what it, keep talking I'm gonna look it up
please look it up. So I couldn't find it. I looked for this because it talked all about how the eggs are laid and how
five
a queen
bucks
is,
says Chris finds it in 2 minutes.
Alien gestation period.
Mike wanted to leave it on purpose. It's like 72 hours.
That sounds about right.
Go ahead, Mike. Keep going.
So the only way I can come at the kaiju is eventually have a day to start laying eggs.
Have a day? How long are you hiding?
Well, I'm
going to wait from sun up to sundown.
That's the whole point of this is that I'm running in the opposite fucking direction from the kaiju, hoping I can make enough eggs and enough time to come back with an army.
How big is a regular xenomorph?
I'll look that up. I'll look that up.
If you're 20 feet, remember. What's a normal one, like 10?
Five. But he can't. He had the xenomorph have to inject like they have to like the facehuggers have to get people right.
Yeah.
So I mean, he has to have something
that's
to clutch onto to make an army.
Well, in this giant fight of all of us, I'm coming to conclusion that humans are running in every direction.
Yeah, but then like your eggs are going to be to size too, so your eggs are going to be way bigger. The facehugger is not going to be able to ingest a human because humans are so tiny.
Facehuggers.
Because your eggs are going to be bigger. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, I
since
get what
you're
yeah,
big, your
yeah.
eggs are also going to be just a big size. Like, your egg will probably be the size of an apartment block.
No, the eggs that she lays are the same size. The eggs that we see in the movies are the same size.
But aren't you, like I said,
you walk over
see,
top of them.
See, Martin's definition of to scale means that he wants all of our monsters to be the same size.
Isn't that what it is?
That's
is that
what a, his definition of
no,
it is.
No, to scale, Martin, is your size. Like, if okay, in real life as compared to the movie. So if he's 7 feet in the movie, he's 7 feet in real life.
I totally misread that.
I knew that you guys had been on two separate pages, and I didn't say anything until now.
I thought we all become the same size. That's what I talked to Chris last night. I'm like, oh, we're all the same size, right?
I wanted this to play out on air. Yeah.
Please, Chris, what's up?
I fucking found it.
You did?
I told you. 2 minutes.
Okay. All right. I'm not.
The
I'm
top, the Alien Wiki, which Forum Post quoted, I think they came to be about 6 to 8 hours.
Okay, so.
And you were right about the 15 eggs per minute or whatever it was.
I will tell you that I was only looking at Alien Queen references, and the three pages that I looked at, fandom and.
How does another Alien Queen become?
Like, they do talk about it briefly.
Do I want to know, actually, now
is it
that
like
I'm thinking
bees?
About
is it
well,
like
no,
bees?
There's
yeah. This is like an HP Lovecraft thing going on or whatever. So
someone should just pick a theme.
Some of the movies have explained that they molt into queens just genetically. Like it's just over time. Someone
evolves into a queen.
Someone evolves into a queen.
I feel
and there
like
was also
it would be a bee thing.
That's what
of,
I thought.
Right?
They just want
like they have the royal jelly, and if they need a new queen, then they turn one of those eggs into a queen egg.
Well, royal jelly Sully's actually mentioned like many times throughout the argument.
I have a friend that's an amateur apiarist, and he has told me about how you create queens in beehives. So.
Well, there you go. So the royal jelly theory is not just for xenomorphs.
So if you feed a bunch of royal jelly to an egg.
Well, they're bugs. They call them bugs in the movie. So, I mean, they would like.
All I know is I'm sweating, and I think my 10 minutes are up.
Are those things related?
So all we know is Mike is hiding for 8 hours.
Yeah.
Six to eight hours. Okay.
I guess we weren't going for like exciting kind of fight, but.
and battle, Mike runs. Yeah. I'll be right back.
Well, no, there's many other. I wanted to pick something so we had range. I also have a deep affinity for the Alien series. And
I don't think she would appreciate your views on her very much.
Not liking that.
Just go hide for a while.
I clearly know how everybody thinks. Martin, do you want to take the floor here?
I appreciate your love of the Alien series and why you brought it forward.
Thank you. Just a little pause.
I totally misread that. I thought we were all going to be like enlarged by some sort of race and we're all fighting at the same size.
I think if you...
That's what I said in the chat, though. I said we're all going to be enlarged by a ray. Like,
and when I said
size,
to
right?
scale...
You did not say that in the chat.
I thought I said that.
We could read the chat. You were enlarged by a zapping ray. And
not a ray, but I thought we're all going to be like the same size. I said the same size, not a ray, but I thought we were going
to
be the same.
Hank Pym is not allowed to be a part of this debate.
I love when two people have a different definition of something. Like, so everything's going to be to scale, right? Absolutely.
I only came out on the bad side of that because my debate's not the best. I didn't come on the bad side of that because of the size.
I love this humor. But I also think Hellboy's like different sizes, isn't he?
Yeah, when he turns into the thing, like when he turns into the demon,
yeah,
like the full demon, he turns into Leviathan. I don't mean to, but I'm just saying, like, I thought for his sake, like his alien queen, like I thought he was going to be like a big alien queen.
I have,
you know?
You guys thought you were all going to be my size.
Yeah.
So not what I thought.
I thought he was going to be like a big alien. I thought that's what I wanted to see. I thought that'd be cool to see like a big alien queen battling.
I think it's a great idea.
It would have given. It would have given like I don't know. Like why didn't you pick someone who can get big? Like I just. I don't get it.
Well, I was going to say. I think one last point for yours is I think if you'd given it like. She protects the hive, right?
Yeah.
So I think you should have had that instead as your premise of there is a hive, you're protecting it, and now this battle is going on, and you have to take us out. So that gives you the reason to fight. As opposed to...
I'm just
going to go make the hive.
I also feel as though if you, in preparation of this battle, which she clearly would have known about, she would have created all these eggs over the last 6 months that they were hyping up the battle.
But here's what
and
I'm
she'd
saying,
have an
like,
army ready to go.
I was giving myself a 24-hour window just after I realized that I was like, okay, if I include this,
you
I have to be
make
realistic.
A lot of,
like this is like this battle essentially is like one quarter of Rampage, right? Like it's one round of Rampage. I know.
Was
we
there
all...
like a fourth animal in Rampage that you didn't see on the screen because it was just in a car or something, like having a smoke? Like
it's the rabbit that's just having a bunch of other rabbits.
The giant rabbit. It's in the park. It's feeding the birds. Just waiting.
All right, Martin.
I just see a bunch of like little, like you got to make a lot of ants to just a lot of ants. Like that's what it's gonna. This is gonna be. I thought. Yeah. I was looking forward to seeing like what you could do with like a huge like if you got a big enlargement ring for the alien queen.
Well,
that would be a cool fight.
I realize now
like when you
that
said Rampage, you picked like the smallest thing that can't even grow big now.
I will not lie. I have the hardest time. Like with spatial ability and looking at something and being like, oh, that's big. Like to me, I'm like, when I imagine 20 feet, I'm sure I'm imagining 60.
Like, I mean, he said Kaiju and I'm like, that's,
well,
that's big.
Okay. For the
596
I know,
feet.
I know.
And like, I was like, anybody else for rules? And obviously Mark's like, I'm going to pick the Kaiju because he hasn't said the no height rule, right? Like we did not keep to scale really fucked us up, which is making it even better.
I'm a sucker for rules.
I just felt bad for you because I'm like, okay, I thought we were all going to be the same size because the queen is a good monster if we're all fighting on the same.
And I think that premise is fantastic. Yeah. But that's not what we're
doing. No, that's exactly. And I get that. I get that.
Because
I
would have picked the Smurf that was 600 feet tall. Yeah. A 600-foot hefty Smurf.
I would have loved to pick the kid from Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. The Honey, I Blew Up the Baby. Yeah. I want it to be that.
Honey, I Blew Up the Kid.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to do.
Well, tell us what you did did pick for Hellboy.
Hellboy's pretty badass.
I like Hellboy. Badass. I just, you know what? Like, I'll say this. I'm glad we, like, for me and you, when you said Guillermo del Toro, I'm like, I love Guillermo del Toro. Like, I love his movies. Like, the monsters he creates and that he puts on the screen are amazing to me.
And there's really cool monsters in Hellboy.
There are. And I'm also a huge fan of Ron Perlman. Like, I love Ron Perlman. And if I didn't have to pick a monster, I just wanted a big Ron Perlman on the screen fighting a kaiju, I think that'd be fucking cool, man.
Yes.
Down, you fools! What do you think you are doing? She's gonna eat the cat. You'll make her aware of our presence. We should use the canary now. She's gonna eat it. We should use the bird, Dr. Krause. The bird. She's going to eat the cat.
Stay put and follow my orders.
I can't sit by
you
here.
You are directly under my command and you have to obey.
I'll stay put. This. Hey. Lucy.
Come back out.
I'm home.
Oh, yes, dearie. Can I help?
Give it up, Nasty. We can see you.
You see me? How do you see me?
We're looking for the entrance to the troll market. Any clues?
Come any closer and I'll rip your heart!
We're gonna have to get a little old school, Abe. Give me the bite.
It's not a canary!
What, you're afraid of this little guy? Who'd know?
No more! No more! I'll take you there!
Come on, let's go, you dirty old troll.
So in your scenario, Hellboy is the size of each person he's fighting? Is that
well,
how
can
you're
grow
doing
big.
Or
it's
is
not
he
that,
just
he...
the size of the kaiju and he stomps
on? No, well, it's not, we didn't agree to that. Then he's just normal. But like he has the power and ability, like when he turns into full demon, he can grow like the size of like a behemoth or a leviathan.
Okay.
So he does have that ability. Let's see. Hold on. I just get a... Where are my things?
Things. All the things.
Okay, so he's...
All the things are done.
He's... got super durability. Like you've seen in the movies, like he takes a beating pretty good. Like it says here that he's even been shot in the face by a double barrel shotgun. Doesn't affect him. He's got superhuman strength. And here's what we're unclear of. Like there's no real limit. They don't really say how strong he is, but like it's been known that he's been able to lift opponents who are like 400 to 500 pounds heavier than him and slam them into the ground. I don't know why this, but I thought this was cool. I didn't know that, but he has an innate multilingualism. Like, he could understand different languages, which I thought was cool. Yeah. So maybe communicate with the kaiju or the hive mind. Or what? If he can, you know what I mean? Like, if the aliens, like, he can
Mark,
decipher
what is,
their
what
language.
What does a kaiju sound like, Mark?
Yeah. Something,
now,
you know what I mean?
Can,
translation.
But it's a hive mind. You don't really hear it. So can you communicate
with
that?
The hisses and stuff. Like the hisses, like kind of. I don't know if they're telepathy or the aliens' telepathy, or because I know the hisses in the movie.
But I always
see
like a hive mind, like bees, right? Like,
yeah,
yeah.
Well, kaiju do have a hive mind because you see that when he drifts with the kaiju brain.
Yes,
that's living on its own. He sees the whole kaiju world and what their plan is to take over.
And the kaiju
world
sees him.
True one brain mentality.
So can Hellboy access that? I don't see how that he would.
No, I just thought it was a cool ability. Oh, okay. I didn't say anything. I was like, maybe he could, because I thought with the aliens, like if they could understand, because I thought they communicated through hisses. Because I remember in the movie, when the queen hisses and says to go away, all the aliens kind of back off and stuff.
So you hiss,
apparently.
And he can understand your.
No,
hiss.
I know exactly. Okay.
Different languages. He's very multilingual. Very very woke, as you would say. He's got thermal resistance. Because he's like from hell. He like heat doesn't affect him at all, and also.
Just me.
The cold, any extreme weathers doesn't really affect Hellboy's skin. The big thing is like I said, the demonic transformation, during this, like I said, he has like the size of a leviathan or behemoth, which are huge. I guess you can kind of consider them as like kind of titans. Also he can, manipulate fire. He can unleash, fire from his body and also can call down lightning and, he can fly because his horns grow and he grows wings. So he has flight.
Oh, he has wings too?
Yeah.
He
so his horns grow, then has
cool.
wings.
Yeah. Forgot about that.
Also, too, like some of the cool stuff that he has, like he's very skilled at hand-to-hand combat, as you know in the movies, like because he's been trained by the Paranormal Bureau Department.
Yep.
Like the FBI, basically the occult version of the FBI.
The Department of Paranormal Investigations.
Yeah. And he's got weapons, which I thought were really cool. Like he has the guns. So he has what's called the Good Samaritan in the movie, which is like a basically like it's got oversized rounds. So I mean, if
it's a multi-round,
yeah, it's a
oversized,
cannon. Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's got different types of ammunition that you can fire, lots of different things to combat like demonic beings and stuff like that.
Like wood steaks and silver bullets.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Garlic infused rounds.
Which none of us are afraid of.
No.
No.
I'm glad no one went with like a classic monster.
So am I.
Yeah. And I think what is it? Like one of the coolest things that he has is he has the Hand of Doom, which is like his big right hand. It's basically a big sledgehammer. It's invulnerable, it doesn't feel pain, and like in the first movie, you see it like a car coming at full speed. He tells it to stop and just knocks it, and the car just does a flip. Doesn't affect
That's
him.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. And it's like, I think Hellboy, like everyone
it's
here
good,
brought like.
It's good when the alien queen shows up in the Corvette, you know.
Just shit, I got you. Hit something. But I'm just saying, like, it's a powerful
station
weapon,
wagon.
Right?
I need a lot of room for my
head. It's got some punch behind it. And I think like
maybe
everyone
like a limo.
Here.
A limo would have been better.
Kind of brought a villain, so I think I'd have a hero, like that had the world behind me to like
That's
help me
true.
Out, stuff like
That's
that.
True.
I'd have
you have a cheering
fighting
section?
For humanity. Yeah, not just that, but
I spit acid
the military
on
would help
was,
me out.
Was Hellboy?
You're not spitting acid. You're hiding.
Yeah, you're not in this fight
at all.
No, if you're bringing family and friends to the party, I'm spitting acid on everyone.
I can't remember the movies.
From a dark window, or
does Hellboy have a fan base? Do people like him?
Yeah, they like him in the movies. Like they have like he's like a comic book character in the movies and stuff like that.
The second one, they add the whole comic book persona to him.
Yeah, it was in the first one. They had the first one they showed him in the comic.
I misspoke.
Like in one of the first scenes in Hellboy, like he's like on a rooftop with this kid. Was like, oh, you're Hellboy, and he's building cookies with him, and they know who he is. So humanity's like, he's like, yeah,
okay. So,
but the government like can't confirm or deny his existence, but people kind of see him from time to time because there's no like Men in Black erasing memory thing. So he gets spotted. But I think that I would have like you know the resources of humanity behind me to help battle because you're all trying to destroy the world. I guess my guy's trying to save it.
No, I'm not trying to. I'm trying to battle you guys.
Yeah, no, I'm
destroying the world.
I'm trying to leave as much damage.
I'm trying to do as much damage as possible.
Yeah, you're stepping on
you.
It.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah, you're. You. Yeah. Anyways, like Soul that was purpose. The argument I had.
Break shit
for Hellboy.
I
just like Ron Perlman. I wanted a big Ron Perlman just on the screen fighting people.
I like the idea of just a big Ron Perlman.
Yeah, that's what I wanted, but I had to pick a monster and I couldn't. I was like, can I pick his character from Sons of Anarchy? Like, I should just be that guy just smashing people.
Ron Perlman should sell hugs. Like, he looked like he'd be a good hugger. And the crowd
No one agrees with you.
That's what that feels like.
That's an interesting point to bring
up. He just looks like a big burly dude, right?
You've been thinking about that for a while.
Yeah, I think he is holding it in for a while. He was trying to get a reaction to Gage.
I just want
to
hug Ron Perlman, okay?
Ron Perlman, if you're listening, we have a fan out here who wants to hug you.
Badly.
Yeah. He wants to serve you his coffee.
Okay, so
is there a Hellman?
Hellman?
Like his dad?
The devil, I guess? The
dad.
Yeah. Hell, dad.
That's probably been asking for. But
he.
That's what you got?
That's what I got. I think I'm over my 10 minutes, though, so.
I don't know, Martin.
Yeah.
That was,
That's what that was.
That was some dead air right there. Dead air.
If you're bringing humans, if you're bringing humans to a monster fight.
I'm not bringing, but they would support.
And I
wouldn't
say
like
he's a human.
They're trying to fight.
Doesn't he command
like,
the Golden Army? In one point, he does command
it. But yeah. Like
is that the monkeys
and
or whatever?
Like
no,
you're
the robots.
You're forgetting he also can do spells, too. Like he can
he can conjure fire lightning.
Magic spells. Like he does refer to, there's a book in the movie that he refers
to.
Well,
I didn't mention, but he has a lot of trinkets, little magical things. But I think that's more for, I'm not sure if it would translate here. I don't think it would work in a kaiju or an alien queen, so that's why I didn't really bring it up. Like, the thing that I think the most would affect that he can conjure lightning and fire, which in this case would be detrimental for you.
I'm hiding, remember?
Yeah.
So. You can't find me. All right, well, moving on. Kaiju, go.
When you explained this thing to me about giant monsters fighting and we said pick a big monster to bring to a fight, I said I'm going to pick one of the biggest monsters that I know.
Sir, I have a third signature emerging for the breach.
Third signature emerging for the breach.
Triple event.
God, I was right.
How big is it? What category?
Category 5.
Striker! It's category 5. The first ever.
And I knew it was kaiju. I didn't even have to ask you. I just had a feeling.
So I'm a big fan of the original Pacific Rim movie. the concept of kaijus emerging. If you haven't watched Pacific Rim, it's, I think it's fantastic. I think it's giant robots battling giant monsters.
I just want to say like that for the kaiju purpose. Like I thought it was cool in ancient Japan. Like they would blame kaiju on natural disasters like earthquakes and typhoons, saying yes. that they were the ones who caused it and not like nature. So that's the myth behind the kaiju cool lore, beings.
Right. Yeah. So kaiju means monster. And at the beginning of Pacific Rim, they lay this out. They say in there that big monster, when actually daikaiju is the term for big monster. Mm-hmm. So and Jaegers in this movie are hunters.
Yes.
So that's German for hunter, right? So anyways, it's like the kaiju emerge.
Jägermeister means hunter meister? Hunter mister?
Master hunter.
Master hunter. That's
master.
Cool.
Okay. Yeah. So anyways, it's basically they explain it when everybody was worried and looking to the cosmos that they thought the threat was going to come from outer space. Little do they know that threat was going to come from deep below the ocean where the breach was opened to an alternate universe, a rip in time and space called the breach, that from the breach emerged kaiju. Kaiju getting progressively giant monsters that emerged, each one being produced from a hive mind that learns from its defeat at the hands of, like, the first one that came out had a giant like blade head. It was a pretty badass knife head. Yeah. And they defeated, the humans defeated it. So they took what?
How they defeated it again? I just can't remember.
The human, they just like rockets, missiles, whatever they had on hand.
And it
right?
Was,
like,
wasn't prepared for that.
Yeah. Nobody was prepared for it. It destroyed San Francisco and the whole Bay Area, right?
Huge, wreaked havoc everywhere.
Yeah. And then they thought, oh, it's dead. Like we're going to like pay homage to the whole thing. And 6 months later, the second kaiju attacked Manila in the Philippines.
Was that from the same riff?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. They all come from the breach, the same area. So the second one attacks the Philippines. The third one attacks Cabo in Mexico, destroys it. And the fourth one emerged, but they don't say which city it destroys. So by that time, they're like, we need to fucking do something about this. So they start the whole Jaeger program. Anyways, big ass robots to battle so the
tell
kaiju.
Tell us about your monster.
So during the concept of the whole thing, I've got to give you the background of what kaiju are.
Yeah.
So context. Hive mind that's forever creating these monsters. So when they detect approaching the end of the first movie that the breach is going to be compromised because they're sending, Earth is going to try to destroy the breach so that we can no longer send, we the kaiju hive mind. So they send my choice, which in the movie isn't named, but it's the only class 5 kaiju that's sent. So the Earth classifies them by strength and power. So it gets classified as the only class 5 kaiju ever to emerge. In the novelization of the movie, they name it Slattern is the last one. Slattern is actually comes from the 17th century, and it's a derogatory term for like a promiscuous or dirty woman, sort of like slut. And it's named because dirty when it slattern. Emerges, one of the commanders, one of the guys says, oh, that's a big bitch. So it's developed the name Slattern. Anyways, it's I'll give you a quick rundown on the stats. It's 596 feet tall, 6,750 tons. it is a dominant alpha kaiju.
I brought an alien to a kaiju fight.
The only class 5 kaiju. ever seen that emerged from the breach, sent to protect the breach, the largest and strongest of the kaiju. It's got an extremely high toxicity level. So kaiju are actually like walking toxic waste dumps. Their blood, actually, when the kaiju are killed, it toxifies the entire area and actually destroys all life and everything in the area with a disease that's called kaiju blue. It's actually like a toxic dump within the area when it's killed. It continues causing damage and destruction even after it's dead.
That's annoying.
Yeah. So Slattern has thick leathery skin, a triple crowned tail, three triple crowned tails. We were talking about your fancy tail there, right? There.
Not, I don't want to talk about my tail anymore.
Yeah, so I have three tails for long distance attacks. It has enough power to rapidly spin and lash out. And it's actually, I'm designed to be underwater. So if I can draw this fight to the water at all, I stand a better advantage. It's got a spike-like protrusion.
Are you
going
to hide like Mike? just run to the ocean and hope we go there.
The most anticlimactic fight ever.
The body is extremely resilient
hiding.
Against a multitude of attacks, nuclear and otherwise. So not just fire. There's actually
there's a lot of fire attacks.
This one. If you haven't seen it, Slattern's head is like a giant hammerhead shark, and with two eyes at the end of each of the symmetrical protrusions on the head. And so during the movie, it actually there's a nuclear explosion that one of the things destroys one of the other kaiju, and Slattern survives the nuclear explosion.
Yes,
injured but survives. Is killed by a second nuclear explosion, but I mean, if you can survive one, you're doing pretty good.
Yeah.
Right?
Who else has got that on their resume?
Yeah. So, being that the, I mean, it's just a big badass kaiju. I mean, it's paying homage to the classic monster movies like Godzilla that we talked about, right?
Godzilla.
And your Mothra and King, what was it, King Ghidorah?
King Ginga.
Yeah.
Well.
Anywho.
Ghidorah.
Ghidorah. Yeah. So it's like the classic monsters brought to life, and they all have different shapes and forms, and they kind of look like, and it reminded me of Rampage, each one of the kaiju that emerged kind of reminds you of a creature. Like this one kind of looks like a giant crocodile, and this one, so I look like a giant hammerhead shark. So that's made me think for Rampage. It's like, well, there was like a giant wolf, and there's a giant monkey, and there's a giant, like, was it alligator?
Yes.
Right?
Monkey, wolf. Alligator.
Yeah, so they're like giant, like regular animals.
Think
it was
a crocodile.
The Slattern kaiju was kind of like a giant hammerhead shark brought to life. Right?
Okay.
So in the play of Rampage, it's like a creature that looks recognizable to you, but in monster form.
Interesting.
So that was my play on it, that it's kind of a hammerhead shark brought to life as a monster. That could have worked through some crazy experiment like in Rampage where it's genetic experiment on a shark that suddenly, you know, morphs into a crazy creature.
What would you do to us with your kaiju?
I don't know.
Nothing for Mike because Mike's hiding. So nothing for Mike.
like what's your plan of attack here? And I mean, I'm asking this.
I don't think he needs
incredibly
one. He just smashes. He's like the Hulk.
There's a tone of sarcasm coming off me because I'm like, all you have to do is step on us. And we're like,
speak,
I mean,
for yourself.
To an extent,
speak
because,
for yourself.
Because it, I think, is also quite.
And it's very powerful. And I'm going to argue that kaiju have no fear. So that's my argument to the fear battle. If you play off people's fears, then the kaiju fear nothing. So you couldn't actually morph into anything that would scare a kaiju.
Just a bigger kaiju, which doesn't exist yet.
Right,
so
but they're all one, right? They're all pieces of a whole.
Like to them, it wouldn't matter.
Right. Yeah. So there's nothing that's scarier than they are. So there is no fear.
Yeah. When you're at the top of the food chain, I mean, yeah. Okay.
Right. I mean. I guess you could argue that
killed by Charlie
to give you the silver bullet. I could argue that
they
feared that the breach would be closed, you know, that they wouldn't have access to the world anymore. That's about the only fear.
Trapped.
But I mean, that was more like we can't go smash it anymore.
Smashy, smashy.
I don't know what the end game is for kaiju and
like
whether
do we
or not
go from here.
Yeah, like do they just want to destroy the world and like
probably just kick the resources and
yeah,
is
like
it
just
corrupt the world to their own? If that's what they wanted.
Did they show anything that they just seemed like a lot of destruction?
No, it's just destruction, and they want to keep winning. And I don't know whether they just like it's a game. You know, kind of thing. Like this,
because like why Earth? It
yeah,
must be
why
resources.
I think maybe this little. It's like I don't know. If you walk into your living room one day and there's suddenly a portal to another dimension, and you walk through there, and there's like I don't know, you just go fuck around with shit in there, right?
Yeah, I think the mathematics on like
I think
the portal opening.
Like, that'd be pretty fucked.
Go home.
Pop your head up. Fuck this shit.
Yeah,
I'm going home.
I'm out of here.
This isn't a challenge.
Like if you look through it, and there's like little creatures like this big. You're like, I'm gonna smash that city.
Is no, I don't think I would just do that.
Well, no, because when you come to our world, Hellboy's the same size as you.
Like, he can be. When he goes in demonic form.
Mark, did you like pour milk down anthills when you were a kid?
I think the simple reptilian brain of the kaiju just want to survive and to wreak havoc on things. You know, some people just want to watch the world burn, Chris. Yeah.
That's the Joker.
Yeah.
Not kaiju.
Yeah.
Some giant hammerhead sharks just want to watch the world burn.
All right. Well,
and for plus, we originally talked about which city would you take. There's the Burger of Time.
I was going to say it's when Burger comes out. It's
Burger Time.
Yeah, Burger Time.
I would definitely attack a city with a really large building. Like I was picturing, like because you talked about where would you destroy?
Yeah.
And with a little bit of humor, if I was the giant kaiju, I would actually attack like the world's largest building at that time, and it would be a very phallic attack. I might deep throat. Like deep throat the CN Tower. Whilst I destroy the rest of Toronto. Something along those lines.
I'm going to hold on to that image for a very long time.
Yeah, that would have been my my phallic destruction of
that. Would
that
been your finishing move? Yeah. I'm done with you, Toronto.
Cowboy, don't kill me. Let me suck your dick.
Oh, dirty kaiju. All right, well, I feel that this is the perfect time to do the voting round. So everybody grab your phones, and let's put on...
Still never found a good app to do this, but whatever.
I still have the last one that I did. Like I
ready?
All right, hang on here.
Oh, just so you know, Hellboy actually killed a god. In one of the movies.
All right. Forgot to say I'm that in my argument. Hang on. I gotta get my pencil.
Kill the forest god.
It's too late now.
Kill the forest god.
Can't take that into account.
All right. Everybody ready?
Yeah.
I am ready.
On the count of three. 1, 2, 3.
I put Chris it.
I put Mark.
I put Alien Queen.
Chris wins. Chris wins.
Chris wins.
That's amazing. And I I don't think you anticipated that, did you, Chris?
No, well, I felt good about this one.
You felt good about this?
That was a good argument. Like, that was a solid argument.
Because it was fun trying to come up with, like, and I could have spent more time, especially with the kaiju one. When I was like, that will make or break, I feel, if I win or not. It was just fun coming up with, like, what are they...
I feel like when you broke the fourth wall.
That was
you couldn't beat fair to square something. But as soon as you broke that fourth wall.
I'm glad I kind of only did it. Well, no, I kind of did it with the Idris Elba too. I kind of lost you guys on that one, but
no, you got me back with Hellboy.
That's where it started. I was like, that's going last.
That was good.
I saved Alien Queen for last because I was like, I feel like that one's gonna be the easiest.
That's what got me my vote was the breaking the fourth wall.
I think that'd be cool on a movie. You know what I mean? Yeah. You see that? You're like, this
get
is
him right
what
in
happens.
The box office.
Yeah,
right in the Oscars.
Yeah, that's right.
That was neat.
Martin, what did you pick for, like, what was before Hellboy?
Well, I told you, I think I said I wanted to pick, like, the kid from Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, or Honey, I Blew Up the Baby, or Blew Up the Kid?
Honey, I Blew Up the Kid.
Honey, I Blew Up the Kid.
The toddler. And I just imagine, like, this is before we were fighting each other, because I just imagine a toddler having a temper tantrum, just destroying a city.
Knocking down Las Vegas.
He's like, go to bed. I don't want to go to bed. And just, man, just crying and kicking things.
That's pretty good, yeah.
That's what I wanted. Tantrum. Yeah, like if we were just destroying a city and not fighting each other, that's what I would have picked.
I think it's easier to beat a kaiju than it is to get a toddler to stop crying.
I mean, true enough.
Just pick your battles, but Mark, did you?
Because I knew that, I knew that people had different interpretations of this
scale
thing. Yeah. The scale, yeah. If we had decided to go along with Martin's interpretation, where you picked a small thing, which is kind of like Rampage, right? Like some regular sized creatures got into big creatures.
Yeah.
I thought like it's a little bit out there, but I thought like the. You know, in the really shitty version of Hulk, where he feeds the same gamma rays to the dogs, and Hulk's battling the dogs. I'm like, I think like a gamma ray ridden dog, enlarged to the size of a giant creature, destroying a city would be pretty cool. Like the dog creature.
Yeah, no, like a giant.
I thought that would be
like,
kind of
like Cujo.
Yeah,
like a super
right because there was no. It was a wolf, but the wolf kind of walked. I thought like the four legged like killer dog would do
the angry giant poodle.
It would be kind of cool. The angry giant poodle. Yes, a big Scooby Doo.
Chris, did you have?
I took a while to come up with one. One thought that crossed my mind though was the house from Monster House, the animated movie from like 2006. But I'm like, wow. I don't know what I would just. It'd be kind of like the Alien Queen. I would just sit there, I guess. But
wait for us to come to you.
Yeah, yeah.
Lion, open this door.
You can hide. You can hide inside me. So,
yeah,
that's the trap. That's the trap.
Yeah, and then I get you.
That's where it gets you. Yeah,
my game plan.
Yeah, that was my only. Quickly, I was like, "Yeah, that's not gonna work. I don't want to write for that." So, yeah,
I was gonna pick Kong originally, but I thought like a big battle, like if we all picked big it would be easy to debate because you're all well, unless you're Martin debating size, but like.
But that's what I thought when we were going.
I know. When I know. Said, and it's
wanna,
so funny.
Want to redo Rampage? I thought we were all going to be big. I was like, okay, we're all going to be big, right?
And that's where the devil's in the details for sure. Because
you said Rampage, the movie.
Yeah.
This was based off the movie detail. Rampage.
Well, no, it was based off. The,
right? Or it was it a different? Did I watch the same movie?
No, it was based
did
off.
Did they say this original? I'm sorry.
It was based off the video game Rampage.
Yeah. Did I stutter?
But yeah. was that were they normal size animals in the video game or were they big size animals?
They were big.
Yeah, they were. They were big.
Okay.
I just.
Climb buildings.
I didn't want to leave it to just big creatures because we'd just be sitting here going, well, I'm big, well, I'm big, well, I'm big. So I wanted to...
Big with powers, though. That was the thing. Yeah, the selling point is big with powers.
That's why I challenged myself to pick the Alien Queen because I was like, okay, let's... like for entertainment value and for some laughs and because I love the movie, I was so like, I'm going to go with that.
My argument for yours, the way I would have argued yours, if we had the big ones, you would have laid a bunch of eggs in prep and just imagine a bunch of face huggers coming at like the kaiju.
Yeah, I just timed my egg laying wrong. I can never get my egg
but
laying
But I just
right.
mean even then, like if you get a bunch of face huggers trying
you
to...
You wait to lay your eggs
yeah.
instead of
trying
planning
to lay the egg
ahead.
In the kaiju,
I just
want right?
to put all my eggs in one yeah. basket before they're even yeah. ready to mature.
Don't count them before they're hatched.
Don't count your face suckers before they suck.
Yeah.
I think a Life giant lessons. Burger would have been quite intimidating.
This 300 pound fucking.
Hey?
Yeah.
Giant Garfield.
500 foot burger just rolling over and purring and destroying cities. Yeah.
Our time cat burger has come out to sit down next to me and is, for anybody who's first time listener here, I have a 35 pound monster cat.
He's already been genetically modified to be bigger than your average cat.
He's been carbohydratedly modified, that's for sure. Dry food is this guy's worst nightmare. Cool. Well, yeah, I think now's a perfect time to put the pin in this. Martin, do you have any shows coming up before we
I'll probably be in Selkirk within the next 2 weeks.
Yeah.
At the merch sometime. Jimmy Skinner hosts it. I'm not sure when. We're trying to work out a date, but
okay.
I'll probably be there.
Cool.
Sometime.
Chris, you got any shows you want to plug?
I do. I am doing an opening spot for Jason Allen, a comedian based out of Hamilton, I believe. He's going to be at The Daughter. That's on September 19th. I am on the early show. I don't remember the time, so that should probably start
at
8.
Show up at 6, just like every other day.
Yeah.
You and Jimmy both can't keep track of what time your show starts.
It's probably 8, because that's usually 8, 8:30.
Okay, that's a good time.
And where's that again?
At the Handsome Daughter on
Nice, Sherbrooke. Nice, yes.
Yeah, come on down.
Fried chicken.
Yeah.
Fried chicken
yeah,
comedy.
Great food, great beer, great comedy.
Have you guys had Magic Bird?
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Obviously. Yeah. I'm there every Thursday. I'm going to have the chicken.
They sold out last night, so... of their burger week.
Yeah, that's been
I think they've sold out every night since.
I went to Amsterdam Tea Room last night for the Royale with cheese and Le Big Mac.
Oh.
And I haven't seen this in Burger Week yet. I'm sure it's a thing, but he was using a barbecue. He was barbecuing the burger, so
that's pretty cool.
And like his Le Big Mac tasted like he substituted spinach for the lettuce.
Lettuce for spinach.
Spinach.
Don't
for
like
lettuce.
It. Don't like
spinach.
It.
So it was a little, yeah, like it.
That's not a Big Mac now.
I know. It, well, you can't, if you want to do your own spin on it, right? That's the whole the purpose.
That's why it's Le Big Mac.
But the Royale with cheese, I was like, this tastes like a fucking quarter pounder. I was really impressed.
Royale.
He was doing his thing.
Yeah, Burger Week in full swing wraps up tomorrow. Big thing
yeah.
in Winnipeg if you're not local.
In Canada.
Hundreds.
Actually,
yeah.
Canada.
Yeah. Wherever your Burger Week is, because I know some of them are a lot smaller, Winnipeg's is like 100 or 200 entries.
Yeah, but I'd also argue a lot of those now are like Boston Pizza and Joey's gets involved.
Yeah, franchises.
I hate when the franchise do it. It's like, piss off.
Yeah, we talked about that last night.
Yeah.
I had Brazen Halls today. It was pretty good.
Is it hold up to
I don't deny
year?
That these burgers might not be good, but.
Yeah, it was like the Pinoy something. It had some like tastes of the Philippines.
Longanisa?
In it. It didn't. I was expecting something like that, and it did not.
Oh, the longanisa.
But it had the vinegary sauce that they give with some of the, like, when you have like the deep fried fish and they have
the
vinegar
the fish sauce.
Like the,
yeah.
You pour the vinegar sauce on it. It was pretty good.
Shout out to all the burger joints in Winnipeg doing Burger Week. We appreciate it. Mark and I just did another episode of the other podcast that we're doing. Should have known better. We did the...
we talked about where we lived, how we lived.
Where we lived and how we lived. So if you guys want to check that out, you can find it on iTunes and Spotify and Google Play Music as well as Podbean under Should Have Known Better Podcast. It's been a pleasure, as always, gentlemen. So thank you for stopping by. If anybody wants to follow us online, they can find us on Instagram under The Real Debaters. You can find us on Twitter.
The Real Debaters Podcast.
Well, it actually comes up both. So you
leave a comment. Yeah, shout out.
Leave
say
a comment. Say, yeah, exactly. Listen to Mark. Twitter is at The Real Debaters Podcast. If you want to email us an idea, we're still waiting for one of those. We'd love to hear
Mike,
from
you. Mike, how are The Real Debaters t-shirts looking?
Well, sad to say, the Proper Design Works had a fire in that building.
Oh, my God.
Not in their spot, but in the building. So a lot of his product had to go because it had smoked.
Oh, was that big? Was that fire where like everyone's music?
No, it was a different building, but same concept, right? Like a bunch of different businesses are renting small warehouse spots. So no damage to his joint, just to his product. So that's on hold for a moment, just until he can get himself caught back up. And
when we'll be giving away
smoke
smelling t-shirts.
Yeah, that's kind of why I was like
campfire.
Campfire-esque t-shirts.
Yeah, if you like the smell, stuff. If you like the smell of campfire, and by campfire I mean burning warehouse. Buy one of our t-shirts. So I'm Micheal Petrow.
I'm Martin Navarro. Ron Perlman, if you're out there, Mike wants to hug you real bad.
I'm Mark Cowell.
And
this week's winner, Chris Stanton.
Ooh. Way to walk out, and we're gone.
Today's episode brought to you by the letter H.
For heroin.
We're not still recording, are we? Probably.